Is this shit?
Hello! Hi! Welcome to Black Bag and a lot of Christmas cookies in front of us as we get ready for the holidays.
The challenge is going to be eating every single one of them, and I accept that challenge.
I don't think that's a challenge. I think that will just happen. I think that's what we will do.
Wow. I should have brought more if we wanted to let other people have them.
Honestly, you guys should follow Meghan on Instagram to see exactly how many cookies this monster has made.
How labor intensive, too. It was like, here's the glazing part. You know, everything was very cool.
It took a lot longer than we expected.
Yep. Was it like 2 o'clock in the morning?
We just stopped last night and picked up this morning.
We got to the point where you're like, I can't cook anymore.
Yeah, there's no more.
So thanks a lot, everybody who is watching us right now, for joining us for the final part of this storyline for Black Bag. Now, Black Bag is going to continue, but with a different set of players in January, starting on the 13th.
We won't have
characters.
What?
Yeah. Wait. Oh, I'm sorry.
We're all fired, apparently. What a twist!
Spoiler alerts. We don't have to come back.
No. Way to tell us, Wes.
God, I already fucked it all up.
Wow.
I'm sorry.
No.
I'll tell you what I think of you.
I know everyone's hit points.
Oh, yeah, let's start with that so that Jordan can use. We'll go around the table.
Oh, so hit points are at full.
Hi, I'm Jordan, and I have 6 hit points.
Actually, what's your max hit points? Okay, regular six,
max
not
hit points
your max sand.
Are 10.
No, but
and
we're
I current
all at
hit
max.
Points are 6.
Yes.
Points.
Okay.
Oh, we are?
And my current sanity. Wait, I'm sorry. My max current sanity is 70, but my current sanity. 67.
Okay, to clarify, sorry, we're messing this up already.
Oh my God.
The players have their max hit points. They do not have, they have
so
their current.
Hit points. You're back up to 10.
You're back up to your max hit points.
I have 10 hit points out of a possible 10 hit points.
Wait, do we all?
Yes.
Is that true?
Yes.
What about me, though?
You.
Okay.
And then your sanity stays the same that it was from the last game.
67 out of a possible 70.
Oh, thank you. Megan.
Me.
Passing it on.
I have 9. It's not going to happen. I have 9 hit points.
Okay.
Out of 9. And I have 28 current sanity out of 50. So I'm really sane.
Okay.
Okay. I have...
it's
Oh, I thought we were doing
We're doing diagonal switchies.
Yeah.
Butterfly.
I'm so sorry.
No, please.
It's okay. Go ahead.
We're
go
all
ahead.
The show anyway.
You've got the umbrella and everything.
Right, we're all fired.
This is frosty. I have 10 out of 10 hit points.
Woo!
And 41 out of 55. It seems like I should have a lot less. I was losing them.
You were losing
like the Dickens.
Holiday reference.
I'm Michelle, and I have 10 out of 10 hit points, and I have 35 out of 70 sanity.
Man, what's been happening to all of you guys?
Oh, well, she went through a time flux.
Yes. Okay. I had a lot of issues.
So, to get into it, because we've got a lot to cover tonight, just a quick recap. The last game... They went into the dream realm and figured out more about the ballroom and the creature that had eaten all those people. And
we learned that from who?
From the cat.
What was his name?
I'm blanking on his name right this second.
I think it was Mr. Buttercup, right?
Buttercup,
or,
I think.
Or Mr. Buttons or something.
No, it was Buttercup.
I think it was...
Honey Butter?
No, Buttercup.
Mr. Buttercup. Honey Butter. I'm pretty sure it was that.
I'm pretty sure it was Captain Buttersnatch.
That's it. 100%, that's what it was. I forgot his rank.
Also, I'm going to get a cat named Cat Buttersnatch.
Well, now you have to.
Cat Buttersnatch.
His first name will literally be Cat.
I didn't write it down.
Well,
tonight's going to go well.
That didn't take very long. I don't have a watch. So, anyway.
Oh, my God, these cookies. Are you kidding me?
Sorry. White velvet.
Right?
Yeah. They're so good.
Yeah.
I wish you could feed the camera.
Did you at least bring a defibrillator? Because we might need one at some point.
Too bad.
I think there should be one on the premises legally.
Yeah, probably.
Yes.
All right.
The cat explained that Grace was a person and that the group would have to decide whether to try to save Grace or, kind of put her out of her misery. But that to try to remember that She was a person, and she's been a victim of the aliens that you guys have been dealing with through Black Bag. The aliens have been around for many, many years. There's been flashback episodes, and the thing that happened to Grace...
Do we establish
they're
that?
From Pluto.
Pluto.
They're from Pluto.
Oh, so they're not. And they're even real in,
they're like the they're like this fungus kind of insect looking creature that you guys have run into a couple of times.
Their weak point are their faces.
Yes.
Yes. And you know that all of the Black Bag security force people are also some sort of gray mattered. Like weird looking creatures. That's why they always have the hoods and stuff on. And so you guys escape from Ünderstatement's tech's lab. Mm-hmm. And a couple of times. The first time you, yes, and that's what this is here. I made a little a map for people to take a look at. It's kind of, I should have gotten Matt instead of Gloss.
What does this translate to?
Well, see, that's the thing. We'll get into that in a little
bit. Okay,
use Google Translate. It translates into Ünderstatement technology.
I see.
Yeah. Now.
You lose sanity for looking at it.
So you guys have to decide. You guys are going to, we're going to start the game up and you'll see what your decisions are. But was there anything else that happened in the last game that was really important that we can think about?
I detonated all of the dogs.
Yes, all of the exploding pug dogs are gone. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. Kill all dogs. Enter. Mm-hmm. Boom.
It was quite epic.
It was pugly.
Oh.
No. I'm sorry.
We're starting well.
You know, I made a pun when I guessed it on Never Tell Me the Odds last week, and they gave me a bonus. I just want to say, totally different vibe than this table. I was so surprised because he was like, "You get a bonus die for that." I was like, "Really?"
Yeah. Well, we all know David's a little insane.
No, we give everyone a hard time for puns at this table. Anytime someone makes a pun, we're like, "Oh, fuck you!" But like, they're celebrated. Such a different vibe, Star Wars to the Call of Cthulhu.
Well, it's a good
universe.
Thing that this is your last Black Bag show.
I know, right? I can go out on a high note.
Yeah, because you're all fired. But anyway, so tonight is the, like I said, the last part of this particular storyline. We're going to do a new story starting on the 13th. And
with
also
sexier people.
It's just us with wigs.
In different chairs. And then, on the 30th, we're also going to have a Black Bag game. It's going to be a one-shot with Tyler, Mason, Ben, and Michelle. And that should be a lot of fun. So we got a lot going on. Now, before we begin, one thing that I wanted to talk about is, I've seen a lot of really cool comments about how much people like the show, and I really appreciate that, and we like seeing those things. A big part of what we're doing is we're trying to grow as a channel and as a show, and we want to be able to keep on doing this kind of stuff. So if I can ask that... If you really like what you're seeing and you are behind us and all that, if you could tweet about us, talk, tell your friends about us, let people know that we're here. A lot of times you hear on NPR the drives where they go, we're doing, we need money to be able to keep going, to keep the shows going. And it's the same thing with us here. And we do our best to entertain and, do a good show. And so anything that you can do, telling friends, letting them know, because now we're Twitch partners and we have to try to get our core audience up so that we can, be justified to be Twitch partners.
I mean, like our secondary ring of core audience, because you guys are the core audience, but like, let's get like some like guys that are like, not quite as cool and central to everything as you guys are, but that also
right,
watch.
Right.
Have you ever heard of a Ponzi scheme?
We're looking for a pyramid of people with an eye right at the top. Mm-hmm. That's the spiel on that. We're just...
Illuminati.
We appreciate that you're here, and we hope that you're enjoying the game. And of course, all the donations are great. It helps keep the lights on, and hopefully within the next year, we're gonna see us be able to do more and more because there'll be more and more Elder Gods out there.
And if you donate $3,000 the next season, Jordan will just be Trumpy in a dress.
I would totally. Sure. Yeah.
Yeah, I'll do that. If anybody has that kind of scratch lying around during the holidays, I will do whatever you want.
Whatever
you want.
Within Twitch guidelines.
So whatever you want.
Before we get started, should we remind everyone about our personal donations, like what they can do for each of our characters?
Yes. Let's start with. Let's go around the table. This time we're going to.
Should we start with Michelle and then go to Meghan? And then to me and then to Ben?
Yeah. Let's do that. We're going here.
No.
All right, so we're talking about the sand and the hip.
The pros and cons.
The pros and cons.
Oh, the pros and cons. Okay. All right. I gotta get. Okay. So, con. I'll start with that. Okay. Stephanie is naturally klutzy, but when her klutz is activated, her next dex check is at a 15.
Which has historically just really boned us.
Yes, yes.
In the worst ways.
Oh, yeah. And usually covering us in some sort of something filthy.
Well, you mostly.
Yes.
Yes. The bugs was the best. Oh. You fell down the stairs and all the goo babies were there.
Oh, the goo babies and bugs.
What's your pro?
My pro, yep, thanks for moving us along, Jordan.
No problem.
My pro is cool under pressure. My skill checks are rolled against my power, which is pretty darn high. My power is 70, so yeah, it's pretty awesome. So if you want to activate my pro, there you go.
Now it's me, okay, this is what we're doing, I see. So I'll follow your lead and do con first. My con is the Cursed Ring of Bakari. So basically, I have a ring that if it is activated, which it just, you know, seems to activate randomly, it basically makes me tell the whole truth for about 10 minutes time.
Which hella sucks.
Yep,
which is also for the rest of us. So
yep. It's a ring, an Egyptian ring I found in a dig, you know, archaeology and all that. Okay, and then the pro is Evie knows a guy. So basically, if you activated it, which this one has never been activated, but if you did, it would be like, we need a machine gun. And I can be like, oh, I know a guy who has that.
He collects them.
Yeah, he collects them. I'll just call him and see if we can get it. That sort of thing.
So it's like a useful version of the name-dropping thing that happens in Los Angeles all the time.
Yeah.
Sweet.
But like more machine gun focused. It's basically about machine guns, I think.
I know Kyle, the barista at this.
I know a guy with a machine gun. Yeah.
And he also brews a wicked cup of coffee.
Yeah. We game together. It's great.
My turn? All right. My character's name is Nick, and his con is that sometimes his mouth runs away with him and he will start lying, just speaking before he really thinks about it. So you can activate that.
And mine at the same time. It's great.
Don't do that.
That was hysterical.
And you can make me roll a random number of Rory's story cubes, and whatever symbols come up on the dice, I have to suddenly incorporate those into a lie on the spot that Wes will often put me into.
Rory was another one of the magic users that has spells named after him from D&D.
That's a callback to something we were talking about before you guys tuned in.
So go ahead.
Rory's story cubes, by the way, is just, they're little dice that have different pictures on them. Just,
you'll more than likely see them in this show.
Yeah.
And my pro,
they're very popular.
My pro is new. It's a new pro. Because I have a cybernetic arm now. So my new pro is Go Bancroft arm, right?
Yes. And BSB Care came up with what happens.
Yeah, BSB Care has devised a percentile die table.
Yep, it's right
here. When that is activated, we roll and my arm does something hopefully useful. Last time it shot a rocket hand at somebody.
And it exploded a bunch of people off a roof.
Which
was fun.
I think I would have died otherwise. So it was very useful.
Yes.
Passing it on. No. Come on.
Dom, is this screen supposed to
be? Well, guys, my pro and con can be found on the donation table. Because I don't really remember.
Wait, you're Terry, right?
I'm Terry. I'm Terry Nostrom Hangraham.
You have the.
I have two power moves. One is either I think that I'm very.
I'm on a screen.
I go to save the day thinking that I'm very good at what I'm about to do.
Let's call it an undeserved sense of heroism.
Yes. an inflated sense of self-worth. Self-strength, I suppose.
Yeah.
That is my con. And my pro is that I think I double my.
Has your pro ever been activated?
Yeah, no, it has.
Yeah, it has something to do with your strength.
Your strength.
It doubles your strength. It doubles my strength.
Yeah.
I think that's,
which would be 110.
Yeah.
That's a big strength.
You can't even, roll.
It's hard to roll over 110.
Literally cannot roll over my strength.
Dirk Portley? Is that right? Yep. Gives you one reroll. Oh!
Jesus Christ! Thank you, Dirk!
Right in your face!
In your face!
Dirk, keeping us on our toes! Thanks, Dirk!
I just totally tommed you. Yeah. I'm sorry, I apologize.
It actually spelled out. He demanded that I flip it at you suddenly.
The weight to thumb ratio was off, and I just totally...
You lommeled that coin flip,
lommeled
Wes.
It bad.
You lommeled it.
Okay, I still have a reroll from last game.
No!
Thank you very much. And let's get going. All right, so, Terry, you're in bed.
Yeah, I am.
You... Bubbles is next to you. You're kind of half asleep.
I'm like gently like twirling her hair in my finger.
And you know, she starts to kiss you passionately, and it becomes more and more intense.
Describe it some more.
It's this really wet feeling going all the way up your face and in your ear. And she's nibbling on your ear a little bit, and she's kind of nibbling on your mouth and licking a lot up and down your nose.
In kind of
a paintbrush kind of way. And you wake up, and Harley is licking your face.
What a twist!
And you smell bacon and eggs being cooked in the next room.
Worst ways to wake up.
And, you know.
Can I cuddle with Harley for a little bit?
Yeah, absolutely. So you get up, and you, after your... pet Harley for a little bit, and you go in and you have your food.
Thank you.
You get a text on your phone that basically says that you need to show up at a location with an address for a meeting, and doesn't give you much more information, but you know that it probably pertains to all the crap that has happened to you guys. It's been about 4 or 5 days since you escaped last time. From the lab.
Do I know who the number's from?
It is from a, you know, the first three numbers as the identifier numbers of the hack cells, so you know it's legitimate. But it's a new number.
008. Mm-hmm.
That's four numbers.
But we all know.
But that's how we know.
We are boob cell.
Boob cell. you have a nice, Bubbles sits down and talks to you, and how much do you tell Bubbles about your adventures?
I tell Bubbles everything. We're an honest couple.
She's very concerned then most of the time about your well-being.
I know.
And,
none of you understand secrecy?
No.
They don't.
They really don't. There's nothing
we're
more
right.
Bubbles and I have been through an ordeal.
Should I save that one until it comes up, till I make it?
If it's gonna be a long time, then...
Okay.
Just don't throw it at us.
I'm really sorry, Jordan. I didn't mean to hurt you.
You just have to make it happen when it does.
I'll make it happen.
Okay.
She's concerned about you. Gives you, the talk about, making sure that if you feel like you're in over your head, get out. Don't stay in a situation that's going to get you hurt. You think that maybe she doesn't quite understand how bad things have gotten at times, even though you do explain a lot.
I mean, she thinks the pugs thing is just, like, ridiculous.
Yeah.
And I'm just, like, making it up. But
probably, yeah.
She wasn't there.
She wasn't there. She doesn't get it.
During the time thing, she did have a ring, but then it was taken off, so she doesn't remember any of that past. She only has your information to go on.
I mean, I don't remember any of that either.
Yeah, she doesn't either. So you eat.
I was dead.
She gives you a kiss goodbye, and you head out with Harley. And
come here, boy.
You start heading towards the location.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Well, we forgot about Harley's.
Is Harley on the list or no? That's
okay.
All right.
I think it's just a pro, and it's
next.
Good
we can
Harley,
do it next time or whenever.
There's no next time.
Well, there will.
We'll all be replaced by different
you're
people
being
next
replaced.
Time.
You're not replaced, bastards. So you're in the shower, you got the text as well. And your fiance, you guys live in you're renting a older house from like 1995 in.
Ugh, terrible year.
Yeah, it's
falling apart.
Falling apart. And he's in the garage. And so you get ready, you get dressed. And the door is kind of open a little bit. And he's, is that us?
It's me.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just very loud.
And so the door's open, and you can tell that he's having a very serious conversation on the phone. What do you want to do? Do you want to listen in, or do you think, are you like, it's probably about the wedding?
I might go and check on him and just kind of, you know, see, but I probably wouldn't stick around necessarily. Okay.
So, do you let him know of your presence?
Yeah.
Okay. So you walk up, and, he kind of, he's talking like this, and you hear him say, really, do you think I should act? Do it now? I mean, I think it's too soon. And when you open the door, he like goes, he's kind of shocked to see you because he still thought you were in the shower. Oh, honey, it's good to see you. Are you going to work today or?
Well, I have somewhere, I have a meeting I have to go to.
Okay, can you do a spot hidden roll for me?
Mm-hmm. Find my die. Here they are.
Don't worry about that.
Roll the rock.
65.
And my spot hidden is 63.
Oh.
Damn it.
Boo.
Damn it.
Boo.
So, now here's a quick thing. Just because you fail a roll doesn't mean you fail a skill check. It just means that the degree of failure can be used according to what I would like it to. And the reason that they do that is in things like spot hidden rolls, you want to be able to keep the storyline going. So you don't necessarily fail, but you might get, you know, a red herring kind of situation. And I'm telling this now, but it's so you guys can be educated on what the game does.
Wait, it's been like that this whole time?
Kind of, yeah.
What the hell?
So you notice that he is, he's got like two of his guns out on the hood of one of the cars. And he usually is pretty anal retentive about the guns. He doesn't usually leave them laying around. And he's got his guns out, and he's kind of near them. And he goes, well, okay, when are you heading out?
Not talking to me.
Sorry.
What did the meeting, I assume, is happening soon, right?
About 10 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, here pretty soon.
Okay. Well, I'll be off the phone and say I'm just talking to the sergeant down at the station. We'll talk soon before you leave, okay?
Everything's okay?
Yeah, everything's fine.
Okay.
So, what do you do?
I'd probably just finish getting ready. I would assume that there's some intense thing happening at work, and that's why he has his guns out, probably.
Maybe so, the sun's out.
What?
Guns out.
Because the sun's out.
So, you're getting dressed. And you're in your bathroom, and it's like your bathroom, then your bedroom, then the hallway. And you notice that you see a light kind of flicker as someone passes in front of the door, but nobody comes in.
I probably just say, Carter?
You don't hear any reply.
I mean, I don't know. I'd probably finish whatever I'm doing and then go out and assume that he walked into whichever direction, kitchen or...
Right. Okay.
What's happening? And then just try and assume he didn't hear me and just try and go find him.
All right. So you come out. And as you're coming... What?
What is this? You're doing something over there, and we know it's going to be bad.
I'm preparing for loud, sudden noises.
Who's doing this? I don't know what you're talking about.
What we need is like an entire DM-like just
partition.
Wall?
Yeah.
Just like with a slat you can open up that your eyes that? Can look through.
So you're as you're coming out, you swing the door open, and he's got one of his sawed-off shotguns, the you know black stub-nose thing. And he shoots.
What? Oh, jeez.
That was not as loud as I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, I know. That was pathetic.
Oh, no.
Oh, wait.
And he shoots.
I know the problem.
Those things will kill you.
This is not set on 11.
Oh, we gotta turn it up. There it is.
That's better.
That's better.
It's getting better.
Stop shooting me, Carter! Jerk!
Wow, he just keeps
really?
Going.
I'm probably dead now.
Dick.
So, the door opens and he just shoots. He doesn't say anything. He just shoots at you. Let's see how he does.
Can I dodge?
A shot.
You can dive?
Yeah,
I don't really think you can.
Backflip into the next room behind a wall, obviously.
Sounds like
in the usual way.
So, he does hit you. And it's a slug. Mm-hmm. So you get this, boom, right in your side, like right here. You get
just
nailed.
Your gallbladder, you don't need that.
Nobody does.
And it spins you back towards the bed.
It's not very romantic, so, Carter.
So why Wes just gets rid of us? He just
I fucking shoot each one of you.
I fucking shoot him.
We're done.
Thanks for tuning in, guys.
Thanks for tuning in.
Bye.
Fuck you all. So luckily, though, it hits you in a way that it only does like 3 points, but it spins you pretty hard.
Good.
And you bounce off the bed. Like you spin, you hit the bed, and you bounce
and
off to the side.
The spin kills me, right?
Yeah, the spin kills you. you hit the ground. And underneath the ground, you can see him start to walk towards the bed that you're on, like this side over here. Mm-hmm. And he's walking in, and you can hear him, you know, cock the gun as he's coming around the corner.
Oh, good.
What do you want to do?
Now
remember, you're fully clothed, you're dressed.
I would assume that one or both of us keep a gun in the nightstand.
Let's do a luck roll.
That is a three.
A three.
Under you are so lucky. You don't have a gun in the nightstand. Mm-hmm. It's under the bed, right by where you're at.
It's fully cocked.
It's ready to go.
So I want. So he's if
he's like, walking around the bed towards
okay,
you.
Okay. So if he's coming this way, yeah. I'm over here type thing.
Right. Oh, you're here.
Oh.
And he's coming around this way.
In my mind, this is taking place in my parents' childhood bedroom. When I say their bedroom from my childhood.
Okay.
Yeah.
I got
that.
Yeah,
that was very
sentence.
Confusing.
I want to try to roll under the bed and okay. roll out on that side.
Your three will let you do that.
Okay. And I essentially want to try to do it fast enough so that I can come around and hit him with.
Because you got a good luck roll, I'm going to let you do it. You grab the gun, come out the other side. When you pop up, he swings around like this. Mm-hmm. Were you going to try to like scurry around?
I just wanted to do it fast, see if I could go fast enough before he would realize what's happening so that I could
okay.
hit him in the head.
All right, so what I want you to do is give me a dex check.
Okay.
Dex check.
59 under my 60.
Okay, cool.
So you...
He spins around just as you're getting to him, so you get okay. to him right on time because uh-huh. you're right at that threshold. Give me a brawl roll if you're hitting him with the gun. You're trying to cold cock him.
Okay. 79 over my 34.
Okay, so you swing, you miss him, he Uh-oh. Fires as he's coming across.
Uh-huh.
But it's a extreme roll because he's so close to you and he's trying to hit you with a shotgun. Mm-hmm. No, he does not hit you. But the gun goes off like right near your shoulder and you get some black powder burn. Uh-huh. What do you want to do? And there's a big hole now in the wall.
Of course.
And he's trying to cock the gun again.
Let's see. So basically... At this point, are we so close together that, I mean, it's a sawed off.
You're right next to each other now. Because you went up to
long.
Him to cold cock him.
Uh-huh.
He swung around. He's got a stub, like a sawed off shotgun. And he couldn't get it to the point where he could get in front of you. It's like up against your arm.
I want to try to hit him again.
Go for it.
Say, Carter, what the hell are you doing?
Ooh.
Damn it.
91
reroll?
Is bad.
Do you have a reroll?
That's bad.
I don't have any rerolls.
Push it.
You want to push it? Like
it
salt and peppers?
It might actually kill me if I...
Prove
it.
Are you pushing it? Yeah. Oh, wait. You can't...
It's combat.
It's combat. You can't push that.
As we learned last time.
Well, I haven't even woken up yet. Like, he got eggs and bacon, and you're getting attacked by your fiance, so who the hell knows what's going to happen to me?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
You're going to be alone, crying in the bathroom.
Well,
just like every day.
Cocaine all over your eyes for some reason.
You're doing that wrong.
You're bad at doing cocaine.
Typical 8 a.m.
So, what do you want to do?
I take it,
you
I
take
guess.
The 91? Okay. So, that's not a critical fail.
Right.
What the fuck was that? Okay. It's all of a sudden, it was just like, whoa. So, you, he tries to, that was a, what were, you were trying to hit him. So you just miss.
Yeah.
Okay, no big deal.
Meh.
Totally
need another chance to
he
kill
takes
me.
His, he takes his arm and he tries to strike you across the head to bat you into the wall.
But it's not a big deal.
No,
one might be. 99. Wow. He critically fails. As he's doing this, he misses you, and you have one of those banister things on the ends of your bed, mm-hmm. Because, you know, the bed came with the 1995 house, so
right,
there was a banister.
Oh, bedpost.
Classic. A bedpost. 1995
banister. Banister. It's a bedpost. And you swing around, and you hit your arm. I'm trying to go as fast as I can. You swing around and hit your arm, so fuck you. And you break your,
a lot of time insulting me,
I'm just saying. He breaks his wrist mm-hmm. as he smacks it into the thing, and he can't deal with his gun, which gives you an opportunity to either run or to try to hit him again.
Try to hit him again.
Stick the barrel of the gun on his flesh and pull the trigger.
He's my fiance. You're gonna shoot.
He just tried to kill you.
So how many times have we dealt with mind control? I'm not gonna go start killing you guys because you came over and attacked me.
They're not there.
I know, but I'm saying.
All right. We're all just standing in the corner of the bedroom, like. What's gonna happen? Should we help?
Guys, help me.
What should we do? I don't know.
Let's see how this plays out.
She might be mad if we tried to intercede.
I'm gonna try and hit him again.
No.
Damn it! That's a 94!
At this point, I'd like to point out that players, especially in this game, really, really need rerolls badly. They're nice people. They deserve to live. And the only way that's really going to happen is through Elder Gods getting them rerolls. So if you like your characters alive and would like to donate... Rerolls, it's the way to go.
If you want to see Wes flip coins at us suddenly, without warning, you know what to do.
Take out eyes. And yeah, so.
The characters live, the players die. I mean, really, yeah. This is what happens.
It's all good.
something important.
He opened up an Eldritch tomb.
For some reason, my hands are super soft.
Okay.
What?
All right, cool.
Your hands are much softer than my hands.
They're much softer than mine. You have retail.
All right, so so you miss. He takes his hand with the gun, and he's going to try to hit you in the head with the gun.
Damn. This is not going to go well for wedding planning.
And smacks you.
Oh.
Hits you. So.
She doesn't get to dodge?
Yes, actually you do. It's very good.
Dodging.
It's going to be hard, though.
Why didn't you shoot him?
Oh, I got a one.
Wait, no, it's a seven.
I got a seven.
Still Woo. Very good.
Under my
That's a good one. So he comes around, and you swing down. What do you, you've got your gun in your hand. Do you want to shoot him, or do you want to run?
What I want to do is knock him out, and it shouldn't be that damn hard.
But for some reason, it is.
Right?
You keep rolling 97.
He's a policeman officer.
You're right.
Policeman officer.
Who is the second one from Dom? I'm sorry.
Oh, I put the gun next to his head and fire and, like, just deafen him. Like,
oh, okay, cool. Okay.
I'm not going to be able to hear anything out of that ear all day.
Evers.
Just real quick, because it is important, just in case something goes bad. Michelle, you get 1 point back hit point, and Meghan, you get another hit point. That is from BSB Care.
Thank you, BSB Care.
BSB Care.
Ben, you have to get new dice. Merry Christmas.
I haven't even rolled yet.
They were getting the suck vibe from the dice.
They don't like those dice. They don't like the yellow dice. And then I'm going to let you know about this because it might become pertinent. He gets you two rolls on Go-Go Bancroft Arm.
Ooh!
So there you go.
Go-go.
So thank
Wait,
you
I have those in the chamber? Here. I can just activate
yes.
them?
Yeah, you can activate them.
Is one of the like percentile rolls becomes a noodle?
There are a couple
Some of them
bad
suck,
ones.
I'm sure.
Some of them
yeah.
suck. Not many. It's mainly if you get like 100 or whatever.
Two in the chamber.
All right, so what do you want to do? Do you want to try to knock him out again?
Yeah, it's really what I want to do, okay. but I feel like at this point maybe I should run.
It's up to you.
No, I want to knock him out.
Okay, go.
Come on, I can do it this time.
If you roll a
100. Yeah! Damn it!
Damn you want to push? Oh, you can't push it.
67
Never mind.
Over my 34.
Okay, you've opened it up for him to, here you go.
Take those back.
Just because I care.
I know. He usually
I don't give
like
up
this.
On the people I care about.
You need to do a dodge. He did an 18, so your dodge has got to be pretty good.
Yeah.
No. Oh, no. Wow.
It's bad. It's bad dodge. It's
bad dodge. Goodbye, Evie.
It was so good to know you, Evie. For
Evie. Not Evie, because that's a Pokemon.
That's true.
Evie. Okay. I remember Evie.
Eviaten.
Okay, so we'll come back to you.
But you're probably shot.
I'm bleeding out.
But you're probably dying.
You got hit in the head with the shotgun.
Oh, good. I don't have a head. What's happened?
I've seen
Still
worse.
Good.
Yeah, I've seen worse.
I can survive.
You only take 1 point of damage.
Oh, well.
So it's not too bad.
Okay, then.
But we're going to come back to you.
We're not butterflying it?
Wait, did
yes.
you just heal that hit point right back?
She already, yeah. I mean, it's basically well, yeah. back to yeah. what happened before.
So you stumble back a few feet, but I'm still going to come back to you. So I can wake the rest of these people up.
I was wrong. My max sanity is 82. Okay.
So we're totally going to butterfly.
I have 6 now, I believe.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. Right. You're doing things back there.
Yeah.
Yeah. She got hit for 3 points from the bullet, and then she got hit for 1 point for the gun to the head, and then she got healed by BSB care for 1.
And she just got hit again.
No. Don't call. No.
God damn it.
No. No, God.
Stop,
don't,
it. Stop
don't
trying to kill Evie.
No. Eat a cookie.
It's so good, you have to take them away.
Here, right over here.
Yeah.
Take them away to the other end of the table.
I really shouldn't be eating away on camera. Because I have to talk a lot. I can't take breaks. So, you get a text. You've been up for a little bit. You've been feeling a sense of dread ever since you put the ring on. Being out of time fucks with everything. And you've started piecing together, like you've got, remember when you were in Grace's room on the second floor and it was covered with things about the Detective Franklin?
Yeah.
Well, season one, Your room is starting to look like that because you've started to paste up where the timeline changed.
Oh.
And so you're
crazy.
You're starting to well and your San actually kind of represents the slow descent into madness. You have
absolutely
this,
nothing wrong with me.
You're looking at your board and you see all these things going on, and to you you know, you sometimes wonder if you should try to turn time back to the original line. What?
If I could turn.
Thank you so much. Just, thank you so much.
It was just right.
Exactly what popped into my head.
Sorry. Continue.
We are so goddamn the same.
All right.
Yeah. Well, the thing that, like.
Warning, Ben
the thing that I think I'm struggling with is that Terry wouldn't be here anymore.
Right.
And I like Terry.
Right.
He's okay. He's fine.
So, yeah, those are really good cookies.
right?
Yeah.
Good. We put all kinds of things in these cookies.
Wonderful cookies. Hungarian heroin
I'm
cookies.
I'm sorry? What?
You heard him.
You heard me. All right, so
cookies.
you get a text and it says you know the location and everything else, and you you know you c- kind of, you're sitting there looking at your rantings up on the wall of things that you've put up and little notes and stuff. Is there anything you want to do before you go to the meeting? Do you have anything you want to?
Oh, there's a sale at Macy's.
Role play that.
Do it.
It was on a $15.99 rack.
Like, are you gonna?
I don't know what to tell you, man. It's been someone who's placed it.
Can I? Am I making any connections? Is there a roll?
Make an idea
can...
roll for me. Okay. While I eat this wonderful cookie.
Yeah. Ooh, 19. It?
19.
That's an idea.
I have a great idea.
Ooh, crash zoom. My God.
And then that weird one where they pull back but they zoom in so like the world vertigo. Explodes behind them.
Yeah. Can I have your hand, please?
Oh!
Why,
wow!
Why are you giving out these out so weird tonight?
I don't know.
Give me your hand. Close your eyes.
James V, 1971, just gave you three reels.
Thank you, James V.
Nice, James V. Ooh.
Ooh. What's that
I
behind
was trying not to
ear?
Hit her in the eye with them by throwing them. Here! I don't want to treat her badly. I didn't mean to hit you with it in
whatever,
the first place.
Bless.
Oh, cool. Mace gives me three rerolls.
Mace! Stop watching!
All right.
Or continue to watch.
Or don't.
But Bard, don't buy rerolls for
Bard 1971 mm-hmm. gives Meghan one hit point.
Ooh, thank you, Bard.
All right.
Now I have seven, numb.
Okay.
The Meghan show.
Did you make your ID roll?
It's the cookie.
Yes.
Okay.
You had breakfast.
And I cuddled with a dog.
Standingly well.
It's true.
You notice that there seems to be a few things that didn't change at all with the companies. There's a Global Centurion and Ünderstatement Tech.
Ünderstatement
Tech came into being right after the doctor was killed. It switched around to his sister, Anna. And so once it switched around, there was some shifts inside the companies. But for some reason, the Global Centurion company is still pumping out all of these black bag security people. They don't seem to be as affected by it as the rest. And that worries you a little bit. They might be out of step of time, just like you.
Okay.
You get ready, you go, and you start to head over. I've got rerolls. So.
Feels good, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. The cookies are really hard not to eat. Hey, Ben.
Hey.
How's it going?
Make something good happen, I'll get you a cookie. Bribe your DMs when you can.
Jordan.
Oh.
I forgot, we did bubbles. And everything else.
I tried to do bubbles.
You got Harley and bacon. That's...
You got Harley and bacon.
And I don't like that.
Love. I don't know if I want to look at myself
eating
cookies.
Weird.
Ooh, weird. I can keep
That's
my face
bizarre.
Directly behind Megan's
so
at all times.
Oh, you can.
Woohoo!
All right, so let's see how long this actually lasts. So you wake up and
great.
Why did you do this?
Why did you suddenly give us a view of ourselves?
Yeah, it's really strange.
Dumb. Don't turn away from us when we're talking.
I get
to you.
Into that.
Dumb. Why'd you do that? Damn it.
All right.
Back to work.
So, you wake up and you're feeling kind of stressed. Your arm's been changed somehow. It seems a little heavier, like it's got more things in it.
Ever since it shot that rocket out.
Yeah, ever since your hand popped off.
Something seems weird.
You have a bandolier now of hands that you can just pop back on.
You sleep in it, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's a guy who doesn't have a cell phone, but
It all changed.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Is that on your wall?
What?
Has cell phone.
Yeah,
question mark, question mark, question mark. What does it mean?
You get this really sudden wave of urgency that there's something wrong with one of your members in your hack cell.
Easy.
How's it easy?
It's the new guy.
It's the new guy. Yeah. Okay. You don't know. You just get kind of a feeling of panic, and right as you're getting
One of them are in trouble.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And right as you're getting that feeling, the pager, your phone goes off with the text message
about such long notifications.
About, well, they all
texts.
Go. Yeah. about where this meeting is.
Okay.
So, what do you want to do?
What time, like, is it, how long do I have until the meeting starts?
You all get the message about, like, an hour before.
Have I ever gotten a feeling like this before?
No,
I don't think so.
It's new. It's
okay.
A new thing.
It's your arm.
Probably indigestion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bit of bad mutton.
Yeah. Yeah.
On my wallet says it's my mutton. Cell phone, and it also says has become a dick.
Was always dick?
Possibly always.
So you just kind of go, that's probably just food.
And, yeah, I'm probably going to brush that off.
Okay.
Brush it off.
So you guys all are heading towards the meeting. Meanwhile, you're, What, Ben?
I just like you lay this out for him, like this gift. He's like, nah, it's indigestion.
It's you know, whatever.
It's a bit of mustard.
Never count on Jordan for anything.
Silver platter.
I love taking hints. Okay. Nick, though.
Not so much. All right, so he just hit you with the gun.
Oh.
And what do you want to do back?
I mean, I guess I'm going to just try to leave this time.
You're going
to
run?
Yeah.
All right. So give me it's basically a dex maneuver. You're going to be, let me see, doop, a little flow chart.
Is this information on your precious screen, Wes?
Yes. Give me a dex check. You're going to run for jump, over, you know, behind the wall. 88.
Is that good?
No.
Oh.
I have a 60.
Would you like to use a reroll?
Oh, right. I have those now.
Thanks, James V.
Yeah.
Do better. No better.
Is that a 97?
You really don't. You want to push it? Or do you want to use a reroll?
What you have, what's your deck? 60?
Yeah.
You got a 60% chance of getting this roll.
I'd re-roll.
No, I'd push it.
You can't re-roll pushes.
What? She hasn't pushed.
She hasn't pushed.
I'm just saying, if she decides to push, you can't
Maybe
re-roll
Maybe I should
pushes.
Re-roll this one. You know, since my life hangs in the balance.
Oh, no. I'm pretty sure you're fine.
There 40. You go.
42.
All right, so you make around the corner, and you hear him drop the shotgun, and he's going for his pistol because one of his wrists is broken, and you hear him running. He's like, stop, come back now. And you're running down the corridor, and he comes out the hallway, and he shoots at you from down the hall.
Knock him out.
Shining.
Yeah, I know, I got that, thanks.
All right, he misses you. Farquaad gives you one hit point.
Yay! Thank Woo. You, Farquaad.
Where are you running to?
Now I have 8.
I'm running to. I don't really have a place, honestly. I mean, if I'm trying to run away from him, and I'm.
You want to get in a car and drive off?
Yeah, that'd probably be the safest thing to do.
Dumb.
Yeah.
So you run downstairs.
Uh-huh.
And you slam the door, and you're fumbling for your keys, mm-hmm. And you get in the car, and you hit the button for the thing to go up, or are you just going to break through the door?
No, I'd probably try to open the garage door.
Okay, so you're opening up, and I'm going to say you locked the door as you were coming out,
mm-hmm.
and he kicks the door open. And you put it in reverse and go back really quick, right as you see a little old lady with a little push cart coming down the way. Make a drive roll.
They always have little old ladies.
Drive roll?
It's not an action sequence without that.
Can this be for helicopters?
No, it's for drive.
Are you sure it's not two men carrying a pane of glass?
It can be that next time.
Because Josie had a better drive. Just saying.
Josie had a better drive?
Balls. Josie would have made that, but Evie didn't.
It's because Josie drove out of 26.
So
she at least had to have made it once. So you, that's a 23.
You, you scream backwards as quickly as you can. And in trying to miss the old lady, which you do.
That was her head. That's her head.
Oh my god, she's made of metal!
You knocked it off and it's rolling around and settling.
Question, what kind of car are you driving that has a metal
hubcap? It's vintage.
It came with the house.
1995 original.
It's, yeah. It's it had spinners. Corolla. It had spinners on it.
Carter loves spinners.
You fly back, you barely miss the old lady, you hit the mailbox. And you go into the street, and he starts shooting.
Yay.
On the street.
On the street.
In public.
Yeah.
He's a good cop.
No, he's
a
bad cop.
Oh,
shit.
I rolled a four.
Can I dodge that?
Reroll it.
What?
Make him reroll.
Do it.
Damn it. But I don't want to reroll a four.
But you must.
But I can't.
92.
Yeah.
That's better.
He misses you.
Hooray.
The car crash just kind of shocks you. It doesn't take any hit points. But you notice that there is something wrong with the car, like a piece of post is in the engine or something.
And it's missing a big circle of metal.
Not sure which one.
So you speed off. But you're not going to make it very far. What do you want to do?
I mean, I'm probably... So my feelings are my fiancé, who I love and trust, just tried to kill me. So yeah. I'm probably a little like... I would probably go somewhere I go all the time. So whether it's like if there's a location we always go to
safe
somewhere...
House?
Yeah.
Not anymore.
No, not since
the Milkshake District.
Milkshake District.
Yeah, that's true.
It's been something you've gone back to several times.
It'd be somewhere either like somewhere I deem safe. So
milkshakes.
Somebody I know
not milkshakes
from the hack cell.
Okay.
Or it could be this meeting place.
Can you right? That's you could do that, or do you want to call one of them? Because this is all happening at the same time.
I probably.
Who would you probably call?
Who
honestly.
Gonna call?
Well, who do I don't know. I don't know Stephanie very well.
Right.
She's a new guy.
You're not completely... Nick is a little...
Wait, hold on. Do you have a cell phone?
Yeah.
Do you? Because I broke your cell phone.
Oh, that's right.
And I never bought you a new one.
That's true, so I don't...
But was that in the dream?
Well, but it's been
the hack cell did text you, though.
It's also been like 5 days.
But the hack cell did, the hack cell did text
Jordan
her.
Jordan was broke.
That's the hack cell did text
so
her.
You,
that's true.
I either
the
have a backup. I have my old phone.
I guarantee you, I did not
I
buy it
I have my old phone, because I, you know, hang on to all of those.
Yeah.
But
the hack cell did text you, so we have to say that you have a phone.
Okay, so I have a phone. I'd probably call Terry then, I guess, assuming...
Like, I'm driving, and it's just like, I'm walking on sunshine.
Like, Harley's in the seat next to you. Everything's, like, bright. What would be the ringtone that you would get from a hack cell person?
Mission Impossible.
No.
It's probably some new song that hasn't come out yet here in the present.
Yeah.
It's a future song.
It's a future song.
So it goes a little something like this.
And you, dim and you, him, yeah. It's Katy Perry's new hit.
Yeah. Nasal nonsense sound is going to be a real
she
big
made a
movement.
Comeback at 62. I mean, it's amazing.
I mean, she is great. She's still wearing the California Girls thing every once in a while. Snoop Dogg is still touring with her.
All right. So
they got married.
They got married.
So you answer your phone, or do you just continue in the glow?
Terry, I think that Carter...
Oh, hold on, let me put you on speakerphone.
No, okay, all right. I think Carter is a goo person.
What?
You hear in the background the sound of the car slowly dying every...
Oh, no, did you lose a spree well?
What? No, he tried to shoot me. Did shoot me.
Where are you?
I'm leaving my home.
Where should I meet you?
Well, I guess there's that place we're supposed to go, right?
Yeah.
Today?
Oh, okay. We're just gonna meet there? Why did she even call me? I mean, I'm really sorry for you, Evie.
We are not friends.
I'm not sure my car's going to make it.
Okay, well, where should I meet you?
Time travel made everyone dicks.
I'm trying to.
Harley, I'm trying to talk on the phone here.
I really like that. Really?
At the 7-Eleven near my house. You know, on.
Is that the one on Tahunga? All right.
Okay.
I'm working.
So you guys, you pull up, and there's this old car with metal hubcaps.
Well, three of them.
Three of them, at least. And, you know, smoke rising from the engine from where it got some damage from running over a large post. And you're waiting for him outside the car, and your side is hurting.
You didn't even mention that you got shot.
I sort of did.
Is that the same thing?
Yeah, they're both the same thing.
Okay. Wow, cool. All right, so he comes up, door opens, Harley bolts out, runs over to you.
Kind of hi, Harley. Don't jump. How?
Kind of goes down, you know, puts his head down.
Oh.
Do you pet him?
Yeah, I'd probably pet him.
Okay, cool. You get Raise Lack. Is that right? Raise Lack gives you one sanity point back.
Ooh, thank you.
Good boy, Harley.
Good Maze good boy, gives Harley. You one sanity point back.
Aw, really good you. Boy, Harley.
Sweet okay. Harley.
So
Harley makes everything better.
He does. It's true.
He's awesome.
You get a phone call as you're standing there with him, and you guys are about to talk. You know.
What's your ringtone?
Is it that same song?
Well, I think I'm going, you know, old school, and it would actually be Mission Impossible. So
that would totally be you.
Yeah.
But like from the 2030 remake.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Still yeah. Starring time.
It's like wonk, wonk, wonk.
That's exactly
wonk,
the
fucking wonk. Wonk.
He's also a goo person. Well, you don't know.
So you notice the phone number pops up of your fiance, mm-hmm. You know, calling you frantically, it seems like.
I'd hang up. That's not my fiance.
Okay. So you guys head to the meeting.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay.
Tell me everything.
Well, he had a shotgun and then shot me, and then I dodged, and then I didn't dodge very well, and then I tried to hit him in the head, and that
was like, what did you hit him in the head with?
My gun.
Why didn't you shoot him?
He's my fiance. I'm not positive he's a goop.
He just shot you.
Yeah. Would you shoot Bubbles?
But just a little bit.
Bubbles wouldn't shoot me.
Mm-hmm.
We
neither would
have
Carter.
An understanding.
No shooting.
That's specifically, it's in our writer.
That's
it's
a deal breaker. That's a really
wait,
good
wait,
relationship.
Wait. You two are married. In real life,
mm-hmm.
did you guys two are married? Do you have riders on your?
Yep.
Riders?
Yeah.
It's you write it into your vows. Actually, that's why they're called yeah. Riders. It's actually spelled WRITER.
Yeah, you
like I promise to love, cherish, and hold
and never rider. Shoot
and hold you.
No shooting.
But do know. No shooting and only yellow M&M's.
And if David Tennant ever says, "Let's do this," that's okay.
But I have to be there. And he has to be doing the Uncle Scrooge voice.
All right.
We still don't know
do you
what
people
it sounds
not
like?
Watch Investigate Discovery?
No.
Because
specifically not.
People violate that rider constantly.
Of shooting each other?
Of shooting each other, yes.
All right, so you guys all show up and you tell them what's going on.
I had a great breakfast. Bubbles and I, we cuddled for a little bit. But it turned out to be Harley.
Okay.
Know?
Yeah. Classic.
Oh, I guess. Maybe has.
Well, hold on. We haven't heard about New Guy's Day yet. What did you do this morning?
Not much. Just got up, got ready, got the text, came over here.
Cool. Same.
All right.
And I'm looking at you.
You're You're in a kind of a warehouse deal, which a lot of these places that you meet are, and there's a few people with on lab coats doing work around them, and this guy comes up and he claps his hands and says, "All right, everybody, we need to have a meeting real quick. I want to quickly talk to you about why I called your hack cell in. My name is Mark Knott. I am
no,
the
not.
New overseer of the local hack cells. Unfortunately, I don't have a lot of time to get to know you guys before having to send you out on this mission, but it is time sensitive." And then he looks at you for a minute, and he looks at your arm, looks at you, and he looks at your arm. He goes, "Why is your arm, your mechanical arm, shorter than your regular arm?"
You keep looking at your screen.
"Because that's what you have to do. You're lie right now."
What?
Gives your lie a spin.
Why is my mechanical arm shorter than my regular arm? Okay. Yeah. Well, I'll tell you, guy, and there is actually a story behind that.
Oh, I get to roll to see how many you get.
Yeah, hold on. And let's make sure the new cosmic ones are in there.
Ooh,
they are.
Cosmic.
They are. So cosmic.
Four!
Shit.
Oh.
So that's what?
Eight?
Yeah.
It is, right?
It is eight.
No looking.
I'm blind as a bat. Got him. I got like three cosmics.
Wait, hold on, but you need four more because there's eight.
We're
eight.
That's true.
Wait, hold on, that one doesn't count.
Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, yes.
Nice. Woo. And all the cosmic ones, which are new, and I haven't even looked at them. All right.
All right, here we go.
Let's do this.
Yay. Oh, shit.
Boom.
Is one of them literally no hand? Oh, no.
Why is everyone here? Why is my, cybernetic arm shorter than my regular arm?
I'm just wondering, is it going to be a problem on a mission?
Well, listen, all right. They were, problem was, we went through a series of different models over time. They were trying to come up with one that would really, really, that my body would accept. Because at first it wouldn't accept it. It was like, one of them was like, it was like weirdly magnetized, and I kept like, every time I would walk by the refrigerator, it was like right there, right on the refrigerator, which was weird. And then the second one, it was like accidentally beaming our GPS coordinates up into space via like some, it had like a weird satellite dish on the side of it, kind of run around like that. Seven. And it would make people kind of give our position away. Also it loudly beep like every 45 seconds, right? Mm-hmm. what happened? We were actually, I was working with I think it was 3.0, ARM 3.0 probably. We were airdropping in on a secret mission. You probably heard about it. It was really cool. It was supposed to go in, out like that, in from the sky like magic, out, right? But what happened was we got snuck up from behind by one of them, weird, black baggy alien-y guys, yeah? He came up and he was like, "Hey, no people allowed here. You're not supposed to be here." I assume that's what he said, but he just kind of clicked and fizzled a bit. So the thing, little satellite dish, was like bouncing around, going up into space, right? Back onto the satellite. It's a satellite. It's a space satellite, and that's what it was doing. It was connecting to that, and the whole time, giving our position away. So I had to punch him in the face, karate moves, right? We all do those. We're all trained in karate moves.
Yep.
We got out of there, but after that, I was like, "Hey, no more of this. I want whatever one you got lying around, no matter how short, how long it is, just stick it right on there, all right? Because this satellite-y one's just not going to do it." So I got this short one, but,
You got the baby model.
Hi.
That was a long explanation.
But a lot has happened, and you don't have a lot of time to get to know all of us because, it's
the mission, yes. Let's talk about that.
Sure.
So I've read your reports on what happened. Very good, very good, very good. I read your reports on what happened in the lab and the information that you got off of the computer about President Chase coming into L.A. to get the operation or whatever they're going to do with this Grace project. Mm-hmm. We have found out that he is arriving later today, and we feel that tomorrow are probably going to be doing this merging. Now they don't think that you are a threat at this point. because they've eliminated so many of our people.
They knew I did to control alt, kill all dogs, and
yes,
it, right?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, yeah. They know.
That was
they,
us.
That was it. That was you guys. Like here's what we know. We were able to come up with the map of the lab that they're going to be using. Mm. If you take a, we you know, printed it out for you guys to take a look. We're figuring, obviously, it's a
yeah,
it's weird, strange,
non-Euclidean,
you know,
geometry. Yeah, it's like the geometry's
yeah.
all wrong.
Yeah, it's, yeah.
Distinctly,
so,
yeah.
Distinctly wrong. Yeah, we're not sure what's going on in there. It's kind of weird. And they seem to have these cells you guys were talking about that they keep people in. There's two sets of elevators, the freezer, the pharmacy. It's all pretty well laid out, but what's kind of odd is there's this marking that came up on the blueprints, but we can't figure out what it says.
Did you run it through the database?
Yeah, it's not coming
did
up
Did you
at
use
all.
Google Translate?
I did. It's not Russian. We know that much.
That's all it came up with, not Russian?
Yeah. It does that now.
Google's really let themselves go. Yeah.
Well, when they got bought by Russia, you know, Chase
much,
won. Yeah. He wanted to celebrate, you know, Russia had helped him get into office, so he gave them Google. And, you know, it took a couple
Google.
Of years, but he just gave them Google.
Legality of it was a bit unusual.
It was a bit,
yeah,
it was,
a,
yeah, he used great, he's a great, you know, negotiator, according
really
to
great.
Him.
Yeah.
So
you can stop
yeah.
this electoral college Monday night.
Anyway, so from what you are telling us, it's pretty dire if he goes through this procedure. He's pretty old, and we know that he's coming to the no matter even with the technology that we have. Ah, okay, cool. Okay. With the technology that we have is not going to extend his life much longer, and we feel the only way to get out from underneath his grasp is for him to die, either naturally or with a bullet in the head, preferably.
But won't someone else just take his place? Doesn't he have things in
he's got other
place.
People, but if he's made immortal, then we, I mean, it's impossible. Like, someone who's mortal we can handle and we can just fight, and Alexander the Great, when he died, his empire fell apart because there was nobody like him that was able to take over. Mm-hmm. And that's throughout history. There's always times where there's, you know, Napoleon and everything else, where you've got people who were really unique and able to control masses of amounts of people. And when they are gone, their empires fall.
We've all read books, not.
Yes. Wow.
But I meant that.
Wait,
sorry,
hold
I was
on, hold
referring
on.
To his last
yes?
name.
Oh,
no,
okay.
We have read books. I have read
it's
books.
Confusing.
Yes. Okay. It's the shorter arm thing. You're bothered that I pointed that out. It is a little disconcerting.
I'm not that self-conscious about it.
I know. It's just it's hard to
should
look at.
My file.
It looks a little weird, and I'm sorry. I know we just met.
Can we just talk about, you know, things germane to the mission? Yeah.
Okay. I'm right. Sorry. It's just it's hard to look at. So.
Look it up, Terry.
They're not expecting you guys to try to break back in. Unfortunately, you're who we've got at this point, after the last strike that we had, so we have to ask you to do this.
What is he saying, unfortunately?
Well, we don't want to send you into harm's way yet again. You guys have been in harm's
way
so many times.
For us?
For you.
Right,
yeah.
Okay.
I'm not talking about for us.
Yeah.
So... we were able to get you the blueprints, and we have some weapons that you can use. They kind of cleared us out.
Any laser-based weapons?
No, no laser-based weapons. So you have to make a decision on what you want to do. How do you want to approach this? Do you think you should take out Grace, or do you think you should take out, try to take out?
If we take out Grace, would they lose the ability to?
From what we, I mean, unless they have another goo person like her that's able to continually live like she has been, she from all has been around for, you know, 30 years now without changing. So we don't know if they have another prototype, but we're thinking they don't. She seems to have been the perfect match for what they've wanted to do.
They did have some of those like failed versions seemingly.
They do. They have failed versions, you know they do.
Like the best thing to do would just be to take them both out, right?
Right, now look, it's going to be really difficult.
So, Talene.
Who?
Talene.
Talene.
Why am I saying the name wrong?
No. Talene.
Because you guys do that to me so much, I'd like have
a wonderful Talene from Miss Avengers.
Gives me three rerolls.
What,
Talene? The terrible person from Miss Adventures.
Talene, stop watching.
I've
Turn
got
off your monitor.
Seven.
Why are all of our DMs tuning in and giving our DMs?
Yeah, all of a sudden, out of nowhere. All right, fine.
Thank you.
Listen, I think it might be a little bit difficult to approach the leader of the free world and assassinate him, right?
Right.
So seemingly our best bet is to take out Grace, maybe before he gets there, before they double down on their security.
Yes, but Captain Buttersnatch did tell us that it wasn't her fault.
Listen, and that's a tragedy. Right, but the fact of the matter is, like, that's the reality
and
of it.
I don't. What is there a way to save her though? I don't know if there is.
How? What if we just take her out of the equation, meaning like we kidnap her?
She's dangerous.
Away
man.
From it.
Listen, we
maybe she can
very
be saved.
Briefly interacted, and she tried to bring a building down on us. All right, so the only experience I've had with this one.
My main issue with all of this is that even if we take out Grace, we still have President Chase, and they could just find something else to make this happen.
But then they have to work. Then we set
they
them
do,
back.
They do, but they could have things we don't know about.
Right, do well, we have any access to more attack bugs?
You, no,
you
blew them up.
Blew them all up. And you kill all.
You didn't think about the future.
Bugs.
I mean, it's possible they have another kind of dog.
Like
we didn't look at
chihuahua
that.
Of
or like
kind.
Cats.
Exploding,
or birds, even.
Exploding Pekingese.
Yeah.
Poof. They're just...
Rhodesian
Ridgeback,
Pomeranian.
Spelling that on a...
No?
No.
Yeah.
Shih Tzu.
You don't want that
I don't
want to
know what that would explode like.
No. We all know what that is.
Yeah.
All right.
So listen, while we're down there, if we see anything that seems like it could be a Grace 2.0, and we take that
we
out
can
as well.
Get you at least into the building. We do have a way to get you
do
into the building.
Do we have
C4? No, we're not blowing up. We can get you C4... We can't blow.
Why can't we blow up Ünderstatement?
Yeah. We should really blow up Ünderstatement.
We haven't, because one thing, this is underground, as you remember, so you can do some damage, but the amount of C4 you would need would be pretty high.
Collapse it. Are there like weak points?
Are there strategic pillars?
Are any of you explosive?
We don't have anyone who knows how to use explosives as a part of our organization. What kind of?
Most of them died.
Ultimately, though,
that's fair.
That's a good point.
If we do have to destroy Grace, how do we do that?
Oh, real quick, just so I can talk to chat real quick.
With love?
Hey, chat.
Though they don't know what's on the map. Did you post the link?
I posted a picture. Oh
no, I'm talking to Dom.
Sorry. This is a secret.
I haven't posted
anything. Okay, so when Dom decides to, it's up to you when you want to. You can post and people can figure out what this little message is through chat because they are elder gods and they get to know languages that player characters don't know. So, I know.
Well, become chat.
Now I have become chat.
All right.
Destroyer of games.
So, we have a way to get you in. We can get you in tonight. There's a shipment going in. We've been able to hack in, and you guys can go in with one of the shipments. Or tomorrow morning you can show up as the cleanup crew. We think that he's going to be arriving there, like I said, tomorrow to get the operation. So those are your two options, and we're kind of leaving it up to you to decide what you want to do.
It's got to be tonight, right? I mean, by the morning, they could already be, if they haven't already, they could be upping their security. But do we know how to destroy Grace? Like, how do we take out something like that?
We haven't seen, you guys haven't actually seen her, so we don't know what kind of state she's in, or what kind of, you know, box or whatever they're holding her in.
Can we have like a little bit of explosives?
You can have explosives.
All right, great.
I was just, I thought he was referencing blowing through the side of the wall or something.
I think he wanted to just bring the whole place down.
That can be difficult, but you can try. It just might end up not well for getting out. You'd have to set the explosives at the right time, at the right places, and give yourself enough time to get out, and that's hard to do.
What do you think, gang? What should we do for this trial run?
Well, a trial run. I don't think this is it a trial run.
No, it's not.
Well, it could be.
Well,
we have no way of knowing.
I don't think we should go in just exploding things out of nowhere. And besides, they might have Carter, so we have to try and see if he's in there.
Carter, sorry,
why would he shoot try yeah, to kill you? Obviously, it's not him. My fiance wouldn't try to kill me. Bubbles wouldn't try to kill you. Why would Carter?
He is a bit, you know, off seeming, right?
Just yeah, me. He's a little. Listen,
I don't.
New clingy. Guy just met him.
Little clingy.
Already, he's
so
like,
that doesn't mean he's going to shoot me.
He did shoot you. The
he
you
did
said
shoot you.
Yeah, you're bleeding he still did, a little through
thanks,
the bandages.
Thanks. I haven't. Yeah. Okay.
Wait. When did that happen?
This morning.
It's weird. I had a weird feeling about that this morning.
Well, I'm sorry that you all don't have faith in Carter, but I know him better than all of you, and this is not something he would do.
You think?
Right,
you know
then,
him.
One of the techs comes up and says. Just so you know, there's been an APB put out for you. They're trying to find you.
For me?
Yeah, for you.
Okay. Why? Does it say why?
Probably Carter.
Something about attacking a police officer. And it's Black Bag Security is the one that's posted it.
See?
But Carter wouldn't do that.
No, Carter wouldn't
No. He's only a police officer and has the ability to put out an APB.
Listen, okay. So while we're down there, before we blow it up or whatever, we'll make sure.
And if you're putting your hook on, if you're putting your coat on the third hook on the bottom, go ahead. Never mind.
Well, if you aren't going to help me, I'll do it myself. But he is my fiance.
We will make sure that he's not down there. If there is time, before we destroy everything,
you'll be blowing me up. There's going to be time. So
listen, I will do it happily if it means getting that guy out of the picture.
Wow. Tell us how you really feel.
I would sacrifice each and every one of you to do that.
What guy are you talking about? Chase or her fiance?
Chase, sorry.
Okay,
Chase.
I was confused.
Chase.
I
knew what he meant.
I thought you were.
I was confused.
Like, I thought you had like me. You had like a thing for her.
Yeah, I thought you had a thing. I mean, it's.
No.
What? That would be funny.
Wait, why did you laugh like that?
His shorter arm makes her nervous.
No, I just think that would be.
Voice
we're
in
friends.
My head. All right.
Is that a knuckle?
No, it's the extent of my finger extension at this point in time.
Anyway,
so tonight
I think we're going off track here. Romance should stay outside of
you two.
Listen.
What?
Tonight or the morning? I say the night. I say we go in tonight. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right. Sooner the better.
Is it happening tomorrow?
Yes.
The surgery is starting tomorrow.
Okay. And night guys.
Time is of the essence.
Always the worst, right? Nobody puts their best people on the night shift.
Except for strippers.
All right, but that's one. That is one exception to the rule. Okay, so we're going in with
bats.
What sort of weapon? Bats. There's no day shift bats. Not who the. Who is this guy? Right. Did you get promoted from like intern to head of the local hack cell?
Like I said,
we did kill a lot of people.
A lot of people did die.
So what kind of weaponry are we talking about?
I was more of like a PA kind of thing. What?
Not you mentioned weapons earlier. What sort of weapons do we have access to? Like what?
Well,
what are our resources?
We've got a few grenades. We've got three grenades.
Dibs.
No, you can have one grenade.
Do you guys want to write down who's writing down what you guys have?
New guy. You mind taking inventory? Guys,
Talene gives you one hit point.
Thanks, Talene.
Who?
I need that. Now I have 9. I'm back to 4.
Why do you guys do that to me all the time?
What?
You say, who? Make me feel like I'm making a mistake with names all of a sudden.
I don't know.
Ünderstatement.
Ünderstatement.
Also, Talene, I think I have one of your die. So remind me to give that to you.
They have a old AK-74.
74?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's the new, it's the old new one.
It's the older new one. And it's, yes. It oh. works okay. It's not the greatest gun.
Sure.
They have a 12-gauge shotgun.
Dibs.
And that's the last one.
You can't have all of the things.
You can have one grenade and the AK-74.
And then we have...
laser gun?
No laser gun. We have four handguns for you. Just dibs.
all four of them. All four of my arms.
One for each of my
fingers. I'll take a handgun.
Anyone good at pitching things, grenade-wise? No?
Is that a thing?
It's my baseball skill.
Throw, I think there's a throw skill.
I'm kind of decent.
Yeah, you think you could throw three world's best garbage collector mugs out of the window of a garbage truck and have every one of them hit someone in the head? You think you could do that?
Did you do that once?
I did. Yeah, that was a specific example that I was just bringing up to drive my point home. Not.
I was referring
to his last name. Not,
why?
You know,
why?
Come on.
Very hostile.
It's so stubby.
Well, he's always like that.
I've been through a lot.
Yeah, I imagine.
Also, I'm not entirely sure any of you are even real. So maybe I should hang on to the grenades.
Fucking A.
Yeah?
Okay. Can I get two handguns?
I think I could take a grenade. At least maybe two of them. There are four, right?
Three.
There's okay, well,
three.
Give me one then. Well,
Terry called dibs on one, too.
Then give me one.
Fine, take a grenade. I'm not taking a handgun. I'm not good with them.
I'll take a handgun, too.
Right, what is Terry gonna take?
The AK-74, one grenade, and I assume the shotgun and three handguns.
I'm gonna tape them all together to make one mega gun.
Nope, mega gun. You know what? Maybe the new guy should have a gun. New guy, you want a gun?
I just want a handgun. That's all I want.
A handgun. That's
what
all
I
want
to do is take the two handguns on either side of the shotgun, put a pole in between all of their triggers.
How possibly would that fire? It would have.
I'll
to
take
be
two of the handguns.
No. If they're all like, hold on. If they're all lined up like...
Guys. Look, I know this is our first meeting together, but I think this has kind of gone too far. Just...
No, this is pretty much how it always goes, no? His name.
Yeah.
Shouldn't there be an umlaut over the A?
No, Statement.
Oh, is it like a like one of those
if
lines things?
If it was an umlaut, it'd be Statement.
Ünderstatement.
The map is fine. Don't fuck the map up with your umlauts.
This is all we have then. These weapons.
Do we have ammo for the handguns?
Yes, of course we have ammo.
Okay, so I need it.
Wow.
That sounds great.
Really good. Right. Sounds really good. do we have anything else at our disposal?
Well, I can give you the C4. It's not going to be enough to bring down the building, but you could open a door if you needed to or get into a cell or something.
Gameplay-wise, what would we need to do to successfully set and detonate some C4?
Electronic use?
Yeah, it's pretty straightforward. It'd be electronic use.
Pretty straightforward.
Well, you have the C4, you put it on the door, and you plug it in, and you run.
Okay.
You know.
Anthropology?
Yeah,
intimidate?
That works.
Intimidate?
Great, good. We can do it.
Wait, don't you have electronics?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I have electronic repair. I have a one for electronics.
Can you fix the C4 so that it blows up?
It's relative. It's simple to set up. What you're asking for to bring this down, that's where it's like, I need to put it in this place, blah, blah. But to blow up a door, put it on the door, you hit the button, you get out of the way.
All right, yeah.
It's not that difficult.
Maybe we should take some C4.
And the only time you're going to need to make a die roll is if, like, you're being chased by somebody and you're trying to do something really complicated or anything like that.
Do we have, like, a stun baton or anything?
No, I'm
laser
sorry.
Laser gun?
No. You keep coming back to that.
I'm just saying, like, eventually maybe you're going to say yes. Maybe you're going to remember, oh, yeah, because
I'm not.
We have a laser gun.
I'm not.
Oh, the laser gun, yeah.
I'm not going to say yes.
Come on. Nobody likes that guy.
You know, I was in another hack cell, and they said that puns were welcome.
Not this
hack
cell.
And they were cool. But this hack cell doesn't like puns, obviously.
Yeah, but we don't have time to get into that right now. Not. So, again, All right, so everybody's got their things.
Everyone have their minutia ready? Are we all ready?
So going in tonight with what kind of shipment?
We set up a shipment of syringes and medical supplies.
In closed containers, I can only assume.
Yes.
Good, not just an open truck.
Wait, are we? But are we hiding in these?
No, no, two of you will be driving. You have to decide who's going to drive. Are you a good driver?
I can drive.
Okay.
I should be in the front seat.
Is this a helicopter?
Are you going to throw more cups?
What?
Are you going to throw cups?
No, okay. I'm the infiltration guy, all right?
Look, you've been giving me shit about my name for like 20 minutes now, so if I can't read you a little bit.
So if we have all of these needles, can I stick them in the C4?
Don't stick the needles in the
C4.
Hold on. No, but I'll create like a slag bomb.
Okay, guys.
We improvise, that's what we do.
Guys, no. No.
Bad.
And create an IED.
No. No. We go in.
IUD.
We do the job.
I thought it, but I didn't say it.
We do the job as best we can, but we don't do the crazy.
Just at some point, though, it might be useful to have a scattershot of syringes.
Every fucking time. Why do we keep them?
Gets me.
Just in our back pocket, as a
possibility. If it comes up, we'll discuss it then.
The more pockets you have, the more places you have to draw from, right? That's what my dad always said.
So you're going in tonight.
I always say it too.
Yeah.
That's okay. A weird thing for your dad to say.
Well, he had a lot of pockets.
Yeah. Flash cut to tonight.
All right. So.
Here we are.
Here we are. All right, so who's driving the truck?
Well, me.
Well, that I was.
She volunteered.
Well, I did.
All right, cool.
I have no reason to believe she doesn't know how to drive a truck.
Evie enjoys driving.
Mm-hmm. So are you guys going to take Harley with you?
Probably.
I mean, new guy's dog could stop barking at the wrong time. Totally blow our cover.
I don't know. I think this dog would be.
Should we let Chad decide if Harley's going to go on
this
one?
I mean,
Harley's a good dog. You guys don't understand.
Dog.
You don't understand.
I don't know
this
how to do that. I can barely
work
this thing.
Is an amazing dog.
Woohoo!
Yeah, no, I mean everybody thinks that about their dog.
Can you
right?
do a straw poll?
No, like, no.
Just
because
he knows
understand.
How to poo outside.
But the dog might be able to.
And you do too.
I just don't want the.
So that's
I'm
something you have
an
in common.
New guy.
I don't want the dog to get hurt though.
Right. Yeah. If you really cared about your dog, you wouldn't want to bring him on your secret, clandestine, super dangerous mission.
This is a special dog.
Is it super hard, Dom?
It's up.
It's up. Oh, cool. Okay.
Matt Stropple.
But I can do straw pulls from this thing. Oh, I did not know that.
He's gonna be doing straw pulls
friends
all
with,
the time.
Friends with Eric Habakkuk.
What about? Are they also friends with? What was your name? Something Nut, Mr. Nut.
I forgot it.
Something
this point.
Not. Something.
Mark. My name is Mark Nut.
I don't think that was it.
It was it.
It is now.
Oh, the band Slipknot, the band. So we're asking
Chad.
Stan's
favorite masked trio.
The elder gods are going to let us know whether or not
to take Harley.
Okay.
I mean, we're going to take Harley.
But if, all right, if we take him, I'm going to need to hear a really good reason from the new guy. But that's only if we take him. If not, doesn't matter. Let's not even talk about it anymore.
Who's getting a text?
I just got a page, hold on.
It's from Harley.
It just says 80085.
Oh, well, then you know who that is.
Did Veronica give you back?
It's from the day shift strippers.
That's our sister cell.
Day shift strippers?
80085.
That's what season, that's what the next season of
Call Black of Bag, day shift strippers. And buffet.
Harley has to go with you.
Yeah. All right, new guy. Why is it so important
by a
that we bring the dog? New guy.
Harley has been with me on other missions, and Harley has saved my ass more than once.
Stay out of the dog.
The dog can talk.
Yeah, maybe Harley a little bit. It can't even really talk. Let's not blow this out of proportion.
Harley is the most amazing dog I've ever known. He's not my pet. He's a companion. Ooh. And he's an agent. Mm. Well, you know.
Is that true? Not? Is the dog an agent? Does the dog get equal billing to the rest of us?
At this point, yes, I think he does.
Fucking fine. Bring the dog.
Okay.
All right.
We'll see.
So, by a landslide, Harley goes. All right, so you're going to be in the front seat. You're going to be driving. You guys are going to be in the back, hidden crates.
Yep.
Inside the syringe crates, right?
Right.
Loot crates.
In loot crates. Loot crates. What can we do with, hey, why not right now? Because we just said loot crate. What can we do with loot crate so they can go and get a discount on a loot crate, I believe,
you
right?
You mean at www.lootcrate.com
yes.
/ saving throw?
That's right.
That's
you want
right.
That one. Also, we're doing a giveaway right now.
Ooh.
So maybe a couple. Well, yes,
couple
we
giveaways.
Are doing a couple
where
giveaways.
You can get a loot crate.
I was referring to the loot crate giveaway. So what do they have to do for that, Dom? They have to go to YouTube, right?
And
they have to comment on the video of our, we have 1 million views of our YouTube, right?
That's you guys.
If you go and comment, you'll see the video, it's with Mason. Go ahead and comment on it, say what your favorite moment from all of our shows from 2016
We're making Dom work tonight.
You will be entered in to maybe win that loot crate.
Woohoo! So
we also have a giveaway for, it's an Iron Tusk, what's the figure? It's inspired by Thanos.
Custom Thanos mini.
So
with or without?
With Infinity Gauntlet-esque glove.
Nice. All of the giveaways, okay.
There we go, so good plug. All right, so moving on.
That's organic product placement right there, if I've ever seen it. Hiding in lootcrates.com/savingthrow in the back of the truck.
So you guys, you guys head out, is there anything?
I feel 10% off right now.
It's so great.
Do you guys have anything that you want to do before the mission?
Maybe rebandage.
Well, yeah.
Should probably use the facilities.
I'm gonna make time go quick. I want to do first aid on her
because or did they already?
We don't need to poke people's eyes again.
No thumbs, please.
Okay.
I mean, 10 thumbs does not make a heel. Okay.
I'd like to call Bubbles.
Okay, go ahead.
So that you know.
After he calls Bubbles.
Yeah.
All right. So you let her know what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
She's concerned.
I'm not telling her exact. Like this time, I'm.
Do you leave out the syringe bomb?
Well, no, of course.
Dom really wants cookies. Come on, Dom.
Get in here, Dom.
You
get
look
a
like
cookie.
A... Go! Oh!
You almost lost a cookie, Ben.
Cookies being thrown.
Did you want one of them Hungarian horny cookies? Or,
yeah.
That's what the blue ones are. You're going to get so horny. Speaking of horny, Bubbles, I love you so much. What are you wearing right now?
Put the phone into your mouth.
can you just... Yeah, rub it right there.
We're all still sitting.
Rub the phone.
Terry, he knows. He does this all the time.
This is.
He knows we're all here.
We're gonna have to go to a class because of this.
Just cut the commercial.
Yeah.
Okay.
I love you.
That night.
I have something I want to do.
Okay.
Actually, I want to find out what the APB is on me.
You attacked a officer, mm-hmm. your fiance. He reported you as being unstable. You guys had an argument about the wedding, and then, because they've got the actual feed, and they're listening to the crosstalk, and he's basically saying that you got angry, you were fighting about the wedding
just
or whatever,
hysterical.
And you went hysterical and you overreacted, and you attacked him.
Real Bradzilla.
Yeah.
I want to try to call Carter, but only for the amount of time they can't trace it.
That's really short nowadays. I'm just letting you know it's probably...
Well, no, we probably have a phone that, like, what it is.
Give me a luck roll.
Our trace timer
Maybe
phone.
Maybe that was in the other hack cell. We don't know.
76.
Push it.
Over my
Maybe we
55.
Won't have a phone at all.
Okay.
I don't...
Pushing it. 40 under my 55.
Hey.
She pushed her luck.
Yes, she did.
I did. Can I do that?
And you failed.
I won this time.
She pushed it.
Yeah.
She did.
I pushed
okay.
it.
She pushed
and I pushed it.
It
good.
Okay. So sure, why not? You use the super sneaky phone that does not allow tracing all as quickly as the rest.
Good.
And you
good.
Call him.
Yeah.
A sideways phone.
Carter, what the hell is going on? Are you Carter?
Where are you?
Well, I'm not going to tell you that because you shot me.
I had to shoot you.
Why?
It's important.
Why?
I'm sorry, honey, but it's over. I mean, everything's going to be over, and I have to take care of you. I told you I'd take care of you, and if I take you out now, you won't have to live through what's going to happen next.
What's going to happen next? Yeah, I do.
It's going to be terrible.
Yeah, okay. Well, what is it? You know, we promised that we could do everything together, so I can share this with you.
I'll tell you in person.
No, I don't want to get shot again. And, you know, that how really about, hurt my feelings.
How about smothering? Is that okay?
No! Ugh.
What's he saying?
Nothing. None of your business, Nick.
He's been smothering her for years. We're full of the puns tonight. Yeah.
More creative wordplay.
Yes. I'm sorry, I can't tell you what's happening, but I've been told I have to take you out.
Well,
it comes from higher up.
I thought we were more than that, Carter.
We of course, I love you very much, but I can't let you go through what's going to happen in the next couple of days.
You know, I really thought you'd been replaced by someone or something else. And now I'm realizing it's just you, and that maybe you're just a terrible person, and I'll hang up on him.
Oh.
That was some strong language.
How'd it go?
Nick, it went fine.
Nick, you should comfort her.
It's time.
With your with your short metal arm.
We're going to eat our popcorn.
That can barely get around her.
There.
It's really creepy.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
We should go.
Okay.
So where are we going in? We come in where?
You're gonna park elevator. At the main docks. You guys are gonna unload your cargo.
Not pictured?
Nope, that's a different map I didn't do. So we were only able to find this map.
You're the worst, not.
I know, I'm terrible.
And I do mean that. I mean it. He's the worst.
Never make a map again. Fuck off. And you take it to the service elevators, to the freight elevators, and you go down and you put it in the pharmacy, and then you're in.
And then the lab is where we suspect the holding grace.
Yeah.
All right. Any reason that we should investigate anything else in the lab?
I don't know if you should. Down towards the bottom looks like something that I don't understand, and it just makes me kind of nervous.
Yeah, like, why would they take the time to, like, shape all that out on the blueprint? It's weird.
I don't know. Do you take any time to, like, study it? Does anybody?
Oh, yeah, we probably would.
Yep,
before.
I do it.
I definitely want
to. Sand rolls, everybody.
Okay.
Wow.
Hello.
Oh, man.
Did you make it?
No. That's like...
That fucking A, man.
Stop lommeling things.
You put it all the way to the other end of the table.
You're lommeler. Yeah, I did not make it.
Like, you literally can't
so
reach.
So much better. But
this was Dom's idea.
Wait.
I'm just saying.
Actually, this is a wonderful idea.
This is how GMs feel.
Cool. Didn't make it.
Didn't make it.
Do you want these back?
Yeah. Thanks.
Didn't make it.
Oh,
we are so insane.
These blueprints.
I didn't make it. That's a 37.
You didn't make it with a 37?
I have a 30.
Cool.
Sanity right now.
All
right.
So as you're looking at these weird angles.
My brain.
You start getting flashes of a finger.
Hope it's not thumbs.
And it's this gray finger with a silver ring on it.
Yeah, I know
disembodied,
that.
A solo finger, sitting on a, you know, desk in a cluttered office.
Oh, shnikey.
And you're all kind of sitting there looking at it. You're standing there. You're in a janitor's uniform. You've got on your business attire. Terry was there.
A different person.
You're not there, yeah.
And you see a guy sitting in a chair, and he's kind of slumped over a little bit, and this, you know, finger sitting in the box next to it. It has all these same kind of markings and these same kind of letterings all over the finger.
He's getting blown by my wife.
What?
And he
not while we were in
it.
There.
Huh?
Not while we were in there.
No. You snuck her out later, right. After all that happened. Okay. But he's sitting there in front of his desk, and you just see the back of him. And you're all suddenly in this place. You're kind of out of time, weirdly.
Am I there too?
You're all there, but you're not.
But
you're,
I'm just like.
You're kind of like.
On the outside.
Yeah. You don't feel like yourself. You feel like someone
else.
This is the real timeline.
What?
So it was a dream.
What?
No.
Oh, this
no.
is a dream.
This is the real, real timeline.
What? I pull out my dream what? Journal.
What? Who?
Make what? Some notations in my Moleskine notebook.
Moleskine?
Moleskine?
That's how it's actually pronounced. It's Moleskine.
Yeah, you fuckers.
Really?
Yeah. Is there a, like, a
God, I can't get anything right. Thanks.
A computer screen or a mirror nearby?
How'd your man?
Moleskine's better.
Computer
Go ahead.
Screen or mirror nearby?
There's you can kind of see the reflection from the black screen in front of him. He's kind of got these, he's kind of, his face is down and he's got hollow eyes. You can't really see many of his features.
Okay. I also kind of want to look at my own face.
Wait, you know this?
Yes, except for his face.
All right, what's going
and
on?
And as you're sitting there, you hear something slowly come up, and his tongue like comes up. It's this large.
Okay, this never happened.
Point comes around his ear and kind of licks over his face like this, and then goes back in.
Wait, his tongue comes out from behind his ear?
He's sitting there. You're in back of him.
Oh,
and it does like his a tongue. Snap.
Oh.
And it goes around his face
Ooh,
like that.
That's not cool when it's not in cartoons.
So the first, for looking at this, you guys all lose 3 sand.
Oh.
So you don't have to make a roll to see if there's a phobia or anything.
We lost sanity, Dom.
So everybody loses 3 sand.
All of us at the same time, 3 sand.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
We Thanks. Need sand. Yeah.
You need sand.
I need Actually, a lot of sand.
So okay. do I.
Yeah, I'm all right.
I'm fine.
I'm like 20, no, 30. No, mostly 20.
Yeah, I'm at 32. Sand out under my 70.
Okay, so what do you guys want to do? He hasn't made any move besides licking his entire face with his tongue.
Sorry, Megan, what are you at?
I have 27.
Okay.
What is happening? Okay, I don't look okay. like myself.
Do we hear her or see
yeah,
her?
Yeah.
Oh, we do. Okay.
I'm
it's
Josie.
Josie.
I just Evie is Josie, I guess.
And so it's like a dream where you know you're somebody else, but you don't know who you're someone. Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
It's that feeling. It's
yeah.
Like, okay. This might be a
dream. Feel like
dream.
I should take
it's
off
like
the
butter snatch on your. I mean.
This might be the dream world.
What
the cat? This might be the dream world that the cat talked to us about.
Why do I feel like I need to take the ring off the finger?
No, maybe don't.
Wait,
don't.
Wait, yeah,
whatever
no.
you do, do not touch that ring.
Maybe we should try and find a cat.
Any cats
make
around?
I like that idea. You feel an incredible urge to pull
no.
the finger.
No, don't do it. Don't do it.
A compulsion?
A compulsion.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you, no.
What am I rolling?
Roll against your intelligence. If you fail, you do it.
No, no, I way make it.
Reroll.
GM reroll.
You know
Don't
to
do
us?
It, Terry. Don't do it.
I still make it.
Reroll.
Oh, no.
Nope.
Ha ha. So.
First try.
You're like, you.
Terry,
you,
no.
You run over, and as you're grabbing onto the
this
finger.
This feels right.
The guy sitting, Rex. Sitting in the chair, turns towards you,
right.
and I forgot about that one too. I've got to do that one next. Turns towards you, and he's got these long tongues coming out of his eyes
Ugh.
And his mouth.
No,
wow.
And he shoots them towards your face.
No.
You need to make a sand check first, but Mace would like you to change your dice again.
Do you have others?
Yep. 95.
Woo-hoo!
Hi.
All right. So you suddenly realize
this sucks.
You take 2. I'm going to spend a reroll.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you can reroll damage.
Oh, I got a 1. Whoa! Can't reroll a 1, right? Isn't that rules?
Do we make
no?
that rule?
Kidding.
I'm rerolling. 4. I'll stick with that. Whatever. All right, so you take 4, make a dodge roll if you want to get out of the way of his tongues coming out of his eyeballs and his mouth.
I mean, wow. Do you want to get out of the
yeah,
way?
Yeah, nope.
Okay, so he grabs you from behind the head and starts to draw you into his mouth.
Yeah.
His mouth unhinges.
No!
And he's got all of these jaws and stuff coming out from the center.
No.
Everyone make a sand check except for Terry.
Failed it.
You're totally cool with this.
You
this
failed.
Like you and Bubbles.
Yes, I made it.
Wow.
Woo!
This is like your everyday, apparently.
You
that's
failed?
A 98 over my 27.
That's a critical fail,
no!
I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it is.
Can I push sanity?
No, you really don't want to do that. You do have rerolls, don't you?
No, she used them.
I desperately need it.
Yeah, we told you not to.
No, you really didn't.
Yeah, we did. We said
this is not the weirdest thing I've seen in the timelines.
Yeah.
And it's not.
You throw ketchup back in the You guys stop throwing shit at me.
Stop being a jerk.
All right, so this is for you.
For me?
You take 4.
Dough.
This is for you.
Dom, I am now at 60 sanity.
You also take 4. Dom.
I'm at 34.
Meghan takes 4 more.
Yeah.
So you are fine. You still take 1 point. You are fine. You still take 1 point.
3.
You took points.
I took
more. I'm like insane now. I'm actually insane.
Can I get total?
I'm at 23.
Okay. Hi, I'm Jordan. I have 60 sanity points.
Okay. So can I have them?
I have 31.
All right.
I'm Ben. I'm at 34.
Not really.
We're like halfway there. We're like halfway there.
All right. So he's getting pulled into the mouth of this of Rex. It starts to, his face starts to like undulate as it's going out. And he seems to be like sweating this weird bile coming out of his like ducts and everything.
Don't do cocaine, kids.
What do you want to do?
I want to rip these tongues off my head.
All right, so give me a brawl roll.
Brawl roll.
Yeah.
Rear ears. Or brawl
roll.
52? Yep.
Brawl roll?
Nope.
Brah.
You're going to swallow that.
Brawl roll.
You're going to swallow your...
I have never once.
Yeah, brawl roll.
Can I shoot?
You want to shoot?
At Rex.
Go for it. Yeah, give it a try. Don't critically
God damn
fail.
It, Slippy.
So she's gonna shoot at it.
Neat.
At Rex, not at you.
Well, I mean, I'm being eaten by Rex. I'm being eaten by a slippery executive.
That's another Katy Perry, right? Song.
Yep. She's just stealing Shel Silverstein.
Something totally different.
And I miss.
All right. So
but
you
not
fire.
Like terribly miss, right?
Yeah, not
terribly.
61.
What
61,
are you doing?
My.
I want to pull out my janitorial multi-tool.
Okay.
And try and cut one of the connecting tongues, if possible.
Sure.
The serrated.
All right, just give me a brawl.
Bravo.
Brawl roll.
Where the heck is my brawl?
That makes it 33 under my 36.
Okay, so you cut into one of them. Just roll a d4.
Yeah. 4.
Okay, so yeah, you cut and it lets out this kind of squeal. But you're gonna have to keep cutting.
No
so you're
problem.
Sitting there sawing. Blood, this like reddish purple blood just kind of, you know, starts spewing out a little bit.
Is my hand normal?
Yeah, you have both of your normal hands.
I take the moment to notice that as I'm sawing.
Yes.
You notice a less of a weight because
so
you don't have a cell phone.
So am I rolling Josie's stats or Evie's stats?
Evie's.
Okay, so I want to try and essentially, so, tongues are
wrapped around his head and sucking him into a big maw.
What I really want to do is just try and pull him.
You want to pull him?
Yeah.
Him, excellent.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what I want to do.
Give me a strength roll.
That'll put some more stress on the tongue cutting.
Wait.
What?
Strength.
I was going to give you an advantage. Roll a second because you're behind him and you've got.
Is that a 70?
That was the advantage. Yeah, 77.
So either. So you pull. And
you hurt my finger.
Do you want to push it?
Can I?
You can.
Yeah,
but
you rip my head off.
If you mess it up, something bad
can
happen.
That's wrong.
It's worth it.
Well, I do have advantage.
She's advantage.
Great. Nothing could possibly go wrong.
Double tens.
Double tens. It's
wait, you did double sevens and the double tens.
No, it was a 7 and a 9.
Oh, it was a 7 and 9. I'm sorry. That was double sevens.
I was like, wow, cool. All right, so you pull, and you pull so hard that you snap his head out of the clutches of the tongue, and they snap back into his mouth.
Phrasing.
You snap his head out of the clutches.
And it, you know, all of his tongues fly back into his eyeballs and his mouth.
Of course, as they would.
As they would. And he starts to get up out of his chair.
I want to throw the finger into his mouth.
All right, give me a throw roll.
What?
Oh, what's my throw? Oh, no.
Is it 20?
Yup.
It's probably 20.
Yup.
Yup.
Nope.
You got a 50-30. Or a 30-50. It's hard to know.
I hate when that happens.
Still sucked.
So you throw the finger wildly, and it kind of just bounces. Like, it doesn't do anything.
And I'm just like,
what?
Nah. Okay, and...
We don't have time for this.
Yeah, let's get out of here. Let's get out of here, and then I'll explain.
That way his head snapped. When the tongue snapped into his head.
How do we get out of here? How do we get in
here? He's advancing towards us?
Yeah, he stands up, and he starts coming towards you.
Is there a coffee mug on his desk?
Oh, I thought he was dead.
Yes, there
throw
is.
It at him.
Okay, give me a throw roll.
World's best Rex. Nail him.
You're master of the coffee mugs.
And with that, you hit him. And you start hearing barking and people shaking you, and suddenly you wake up out of this weird moment. It wasn't a dream. It was like your brain was getting reprocessed, like reprogrammed.
What physical just happened?
What happened? Where were we, and who was I?
Okay, let me explain.
I'm not sure.
Not...
Oh, because it's not talking.
Nah, right, yeah. Nah.
Nobody likes that guy.
Damn it. I had a whole spiel going.
In my timeline, the original timeline.
What are you talking about?
I've tried to explain this to you guys, but there was a guy named Rex. And my original hack cell, we found that finger with that ring on it in his office. We ended up taking the finger somewhere, and we took the ring off because it had some coating on it to see, and it exploded, and there were these spores that ended up, and they were alien spores that ended up infecting a whole bunch of people.
Well, really, that sounds crazier than any of the stuff we've run into.
Okay, hold on.
You just saw a guy with tongues, come on.
Yeah, when did that come into the picture, the other tongues?
That never happened.
Okay, she's making shit up.
What? Why?
Right then, Terry, you feel something trickle down the back of your neck.
Like, why? Okay, so half of that vision was something that happened to the other half. Wasn't.
It's the bile. It's the bile that came out
what,
of
what, Terry? What?
What?
And like a spider monkey, he slaps you with his horrible bile.
I don't know what this is.
Why would you toss it at someone, mate?
You asked!
To see what it was!
My mouth was open, Terry!
Yuck.
The Bard 1971 heals you for 1 point.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you, Bard.
Oh, I wasn't hurt, though.
Bonus hit point.
Bonus hit point!
Sand is where they're hurting.
Yes.
Their sand is in trouble.
We crazy.
Yeah. You did? Was it not Ben?
I'm putting your hit point total at 11 right now.
All right.
Where did this come from?
Where did it come from?
The guy with the tongues. Didn't you see he was sweating this stuff?
Okay, but what? You said we weren't really there.
I wasn't really there.
No, I didn't say we weren't really there. I said that in the original timeline, that never happened.
Not. Where did we go just now?
Were we here?
We were looking at the map, and you spaced out, and...
Why didn't you space out? Do me a favor. Look really hard at that map.
I don't want to...
Look at the map.
You got to sit...
Look at the map.
I don't want to look at the map.
Look at the map.
He looks at the map.
I don't want to look at the map.
Look at it.
Look at the
map. No, you look at it.
Look at it.
Look at it.
New guy, get his eyes.
fucked up. Nick is a real asshole now.
I know.
Jesus.
I used to like you, Nick.
Now you're just a cock. Look at it. Ah.
Look at my fingers.
Look at my disturbingly short arm. Mechanical arm.
Oh. What?
Not what's happening. Someone grab
snap
me.
Out of it. Snap out of it.
He has seizures.
And you notice that he starts getting marks across his face.
No.
And then suddenly you start seeing his face get eaten. Just by some invisible force.
Oh, God.
Blood and eyes. And, and his tongue comes popping out of his mouth.
Don't you fucking
and his,
dare.
His throat.
Don't you dare.
I do. When there's gore, I do. I have to roll con.
Fucking dare.
Crap, I leveled it.
Oh, God. It's 80.
It's already bad. It's an 82.
So, like, his throat starts to come up like this and it busts open. And he's like,
at which point do I pass out?
Roll to see. I guess it gets your con, right?
She just failed the con roll.
Yeah. I just failed.
No, you just failed it.
You failed
it. I know, but
so
I didn't fail that one.
You vomit, right?
Yeah. Well, yeah, something like that.
Make a con roll.
I'm just squeezing.
He's a queasy shit.
I fucking make it.
Squeeze.
Can you re-roll that for me?
No. Make it.
One more time.
Make it.
I made it.
You made it!
I made it. I plugged my butt this morning, so I'm solid.
Literally. You put like a wax seal in your asshole.
Not wax, man.
It's glass.
That wouldn't hold.
Just shoots out like a bullet.
But there's the plastic in the pants to keep it from going.
Wait, where'd all the C4 go? Oh, shit.
Don't move a sphincter.
Hold it together like you're just clenching your ass cheeks together. Fucking hold it together.
No, to die.
Fucking hold it together.
No. Okay. All right, so Knott's face got eaten.
Is that okay?
He's
is he not okay?
He's not okay.
Hey. Guy.
I feel kind of bad. Well, off to the mission.
Smash cut. So he's just like a, he's
just
basically
there,
headless
like from,
now?
From here down, it's just like this stream of blood and gore and vomit from Evie.
Oh, you vomited on his corpse?
Yeah.
I guess so.
Yeah.
Are you sure you didn't shoot yourself?
I'm 100% yeah.
Are you wearing your pants?
Always my favorite pants. Okay.
Well, the night is still young.
I am back.
I'm just warning you. You miss a con check and the wax butt plug goes into play.
It's not wax, mate. That wouldn't hold.
What did you use?
I guess we'll find out.
We'll find out. Pyrex is a motherfucker.
It's cybernetic.
It's cybernetic butt plug.
I feel so bad.
Like, I feel a little bit worse. I feel a little bit more worse about this than I do about killing all of those innocent animals. But just a little bit.
They were real pugs, animals.
They were fake. They were goo pugs.
They were goo pugs.
As both Terry and Tad, you've killed a lot of people.
Hey, it's true. I'm really just desensitized to this now. Anyway, on to the mission.
You guys are standing around this chair with the half a torso now.
Oh, jeez.
And all this like gurgling blood and everyone on the exterior that's looking around kind of backs up just a little bit like, oh, shit.
There are other people in here?
Yeah, remember? There were people in lab coats doing work on the side.
Nobody look at those.
Let's go ahead and roll this up.
Nobody look at those. Just don't look at them.
Don't look at this map.
So I think we should just do the mission because it's what Knott would have wanted.
I mean, we really should do it in his honor.
You would have wanted or not wanted?
Don't do that, okay?
Harley comes over and like kind of tries to pull you away from the gore.
And I pet Harley.
And you get a point back.
Yay!
Because of BSB Care.
Thanks, BSB Care. And thank you, Harley.
All right.
Good boy, Harley.
We are terrible people.
You really are.
So
let's see what happens when we do this.
That puts me at 32, Dom.
So nobody look at this, all right?
No. I think the test was successful. We know it's evil.
We... It makes it very hard to study the schematics of the mission. But fine, you know, I think I remember most of it.
That part.
Just roll it up. Let's just roll it up.
Can we just cut out this part?
Half. I'm saving these.
I feel like it's just that
gonna
part.
Be gone.
Just they are going to be gone. I'm thinking you should, I don't know.
All right. Let's get in that truck.
Can I see the bag? I'm just going to put that over here for right now. Just I wouldn't do that. That's
next.
All right.
Starwife.
You're feeling quite queasy, and you know that, like, you know, the dog is comforting.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to pet the dog?
Yeah, okay. I do very much.
See what happens if you say no.
No.
Then you don't get your point back for your sand.
I want that.
Pet Harley.
Yeah.
And Christian gave you that.
Thank Aww. You.
Thanks, guys.
Now I have 24.
Woohoo!
Wow, so sane.
24, yep.
The most sane.
Current, she's slightly saner than she was a minute ago.
Yeah. Hey, that's all the difference in the world. Mm-hmm. That was a horrible sequence.
Before. I had 24.
Terrible.
Terrible wow. sequence.
Wow. You have children.
I know.
You have children.
You shouldn't have looked at that.
Yeah. That was not a good move.
Yeah.
Way to odd go, angles, no. avoid. Avoid odd, weird
Just
angles.
In life. I mean.
Yeah. So,
to the truck.
Do you want to fast forward? Are you done fucking up the these poor people?
Listen.
I'm just wondering.
Yes, we've done enough damage here.
We've done enough damage? Okay. So that night.
We've hit our quota for the day.
You guys drive the truck. You have your badges. You have your passwords. Everything is set up. Is anyone taking point on talking? Is anyone going to be the face? Are you going to be the face? Are you going to be the face?
Okay.
Okay.
Are we dressed like pharmaceutical yes. company?
You're dressed like your delivery guys. They've got you. They got you a truck. They got you the supplies. Everything
overalls.
Looks overalls. Everything's legit.
Generic delivery, or like specifically for this pharmaceutical company?
For the generic delivery.
Okay.
So you drive up to the front gate, you give him your information. He says, you know, how long do you think you'll be on unloading?
I don't know, man. We got a lot of crates. Okay. So, like, I mean.
And so could you.
It'll take as long as it. Yeah, we got a lot of www.lootcrates.com/saving throw. Coupon code saving throw.
So.
We got 10% at least of these crates off the truck in about, yeah.
You're
take
sliding
some time.
Into walk-in just a little bit. A little walk.
10%.
A small.
I mean, it'll take as long as it takes.
All right. Just let us know if it's going to take longer than like 4 hours or something. Ridiculous. Because we have a special person coming in through tomorrow. I shouldn't say
who's
anything.
That? Who's that?
I can't.
You're not Come in on, the man. Back of the truck.
Come on, man. No, I'm here.
No, you're
was that
the,
was
you're
that
hiding.
A was that a crate that just talked
no,
back there?
No.
Did I hear something?
No.
Was there a muffle?
No. Was there a muffle? Probably, but you didn't hear anything.
I didn't hear anything? Okay.
He bought it.
Yeah. Okay.
Good job.
So he waves you through because you know the night guys are terrible.
They're the worst.
They are the worst.
Except the strip clubs.
Except for the strip clubs.
Great. You drive up. You back your car up and park, and you know, start doing the unloading. How do you guys want to approach this? Are you gonna load up one box and go down? Are you gonna unload everything? How is the plan?
One box at a time, I think.
One box.
Well, I assume that at least one of these boxes is where half of our weapons or all of our
Do
weapons
they have
are.
And
people.
A dolly?
Don't forget your people.
I assume right. we have two dollies. Do we have two dollies?
Yes, you have as many dollies as you need because it's a loading dock. They've
okay,
got dollies.
Okay, so I think we're going to both probably push the two
carts,
crates containing those guys.
And then,
and
Harley
lower them on the back
of
the thing and put one on a dolly.
Okay.
And we're going to dolly each of them in. And if we play our cards right, we can be constantly unloading things for a long period of time to make it seem like there's nothing suspicious about us
okay.
being here.
Can Terry, can you tell me about your, is it cognition of the damned?
Hmm? Oh, that's right. You have a new con and pro since you're back.
Oh.
Cognition of the damned.
You're gonna need to.
Yeah, I forgot. I think he remembers something of the past.
Again? Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I believe so.
Is it sort of like PTSD?
Yeah, kind of. It's not like that at all. Not you're not terror.
Violent.
You want me to tell you?
You're not that.
Yes,
even though everything seems to be fine in Terry's life.
Totally fine.
He at times has flashbacks to the old timeline when he died and the glimpses of the beyond. This causes him to temporarily lose sanity, automatically triggers a sanity check. If lost, must do D8 damage check.
Ooh. Okay, so you're in this crate and they're loading you onto this thing and you've got all these like package of syringes and everything around you. And there's this black like case. Mm-hmm. It's just, and you're staring at it. Tongue Demon gave us that one, by the way, correct? So thank you, Tongue
Demon. Thanks, Tongue Demon.
Tongue Demon?
I'm not kidding.
No That's relation?
No relation no. to...
The yeah. Tongue Demon
the tongue
we
demon
just encountered?
Just encountered, yes.
What a fortuitous coincidence.
It's a small universe in chat. Mm-hmm. So you're sitting there and you look and you feel a compulsion to open it. And
I do, of course.
You open it up and there's all of these weird looking diamonds sitting there. All different strange configurations. And they're the same diamonds that Rex had stolen from the motorcycle, the tongs.
So the crate vibrating?
You start hearing all these noises. And you guys are on the loading dock, so there are people walking around doing other things.
You should probably
sand check for me.
Find a bathroom.
Yeah, probably should.
Make all those noises.
I'll just, you know. I ate at Denny's.
Yeah, no.
Ooh.
98.
Oh, no. Hey, this is bad, right?
Yeah.
Is it real bad?
Yeah. So you start knocking around.
Hold on.
What are we holding on to?
What's your sanity?
34.
Okay. So you take damage,
wait,
correct?
Hold on. I'm going to let him re-roll it.
Oh, you're going to... Oh. Oh, that's nice.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's good.
All right. Yay. Woohoo. Okay, so you're okay.
What are you... That was weird.
Does he automatically take damage anyway or no? If he makes the sand check, how did we...
Well, according to that, only if he fails.
Only if he fails. Okay, cool. So you're all right. Huh. You close it and then...
Sorry, Tongue Demon.
When you close it and you reopen it, it's just another set of tools like doctor's syringes and doctor's like a doctor's kit of mm-hmm. surgical scalpels.
I kick the crate. Stop vocalizing to yourself.
No, sorry.
No, don't respond. Just stop. No. let's get inside.
Good idea.
All right. So you guys get on the freight elevator and take it down. And it's a long ride for some reason. It feels like, because you guys have actually never, you guys have never been on the elevator very long. So it takes a while to get you guys down there.
What's playing on there?
The doors.
It's a Katy Perry song.
It's always. Yeah.
It's Katy Perry's
It's a mashup.
It's a mashup.
Girl of Ipanema. Yeah. I don't care what anyone says. That is damn catchy.
So the doors open up and it's completely dark. There's a couple of lights on, but just kind of an eerie glow.
Left and right, I think.
You should look at the map.
Which elevator are we on?
The freight elevator.
The freight
Which
elevators.
One?
Jordan.
This one?
Yeah.
So.
Don't mess up the map. Don't
right.
Sorry,
map.
Sorry.
Jesus.
There. So right and
it
then left.
It is science-y yes. down here.
Right
yeah,
and then left.
It always is.
Right and then left.
Yeah.
All right. So you guys come out. And.
Ooh, a bathroom.
No.
It's like I said, it's kind of, it's really dark and you feel kind of like, I don't know, really uneasy, more than usual. Something's off.
All right. So are there people down here too?
None that you can see.
So you and I should alternate. going back up to the top and grabbing another crate to bring it down to disguise what's going on here. So you two need to be the ones who are consistently doing whatever it is we need to be doing. And then we'll keep sending one of us back up at a time. Yeah?
Yeah.
Sounds good to me.
Just to keep looking busy. That's all we have to do. Okay. Are they also dressed as...
Yeah. All right. So you guys, what do you guys want to do while they're going back upstairs?
Only one of us is
going to... Oh, yeah. Who's going up first?
I guess I will.
Okay.
We wanted to go into the lab.
The lab is, yeah. That's where they said she was going to be kept.
I should... Is there like a keypad on the lab?
On the lab door, yes, there is.
I need to use a computer use on it?
Yep.
I'm going to use computer use on it.
All right. Get us in there.
All right. hacking.
Dum-dum-dum-dum-dum-dum-dum.
Fuck.
Did that work?
My life.
Did it work?
It's 10 over my 70.
You can push.
I'm going to push it.
All right.
But if you fail, dire consequences.
One second. Don't.
Wait.
Don't roll.
Wait.
Still don't roll.
Beep, boop, boop, boop. Beep.
7, 6, 4, 3, 2.
Bam, 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 bam.
Salt and pepper finger, and we're in a fan.
All right, go ahead.
Oh, sorry.
Beep.
7.
Wow.
Nice. 7 Woo. Under my 70.
Ducky. All right. 7.
Doors click, click. Unlock.
And we're in.
First try. Nice.
First try.
So the door comes open right as you're coming back, or whoever's coming back down. You. And you hear the door slide open.
But I wanted to see. Okay, I'll be right back.
Okay. Where are you going, Nick?
I'm just going to have to take
the voice
crate.
From the room.
It's my turn.
Yeah, we know. Go on.
Nick, don't go anywhere. You're finally here. You can come talk to me.
You guys aren't hearing that again. Are
what?
You?
Hearing what?
Not but hearing that. Yeah. I'll be right back. I'll just have to make sure everybody thinks that everything is fine by taking this crate back up and then coming back down.
Why are you telling us the plan?
You're...
What?
What? What? Why would you just come back? Like, why not just stay here with me?
Because
we're supposed to talk.
We're not supposed to be here, so I have to keep up a semblance of needing to be here. I'll be right back.
I really need to... Okay.
Don't worry, I'll be right back.
All right, I'm just...
See, here, just feel how much I'm going to be right back.
What the hell is he talking about?
Make a sand check. Because she presses in on your brain a little too hard.
Ouch.
Ouch.
I fail.
You failed?
I failed.
What'd you
a
roll?
Thumb on your
78
brain.
Over
wow,
my
nice.
60.
Is that a poop? Is that
thumbs.
A poop fail?
No. No, it is not.
So she kind of, she's probing your brain, really like getting in there.
Getting in there.
There's really in the nooks and
all
crannies.
All thumbs.
All thumbs. She's
She's got so many thumbs.
She's thumbing you really good.
Oh no. Normally I like that, but not like this.
Sci-fi T-Rex gives me 2 rerolls.
Why? Who are these Stop people it. Coming out of nowhere suddenly giving us rerolls?
Thank
Stop
you.
It.
Someone named Mace and Talene, those aren't real names.
That's a 5.
Yes.
So you need to make an intelligence check to see if you understand what's going on in your brain as she scrapes the inside of your soul out
she's
of your
just like,
it's good
she's
to
just like tickling a neuron.
It's good to get the plaque out of those corners. Oh. I fucking made it by 1.
Excellent.
By 1.
So, let's see. Can you do me a favor?
I would love to.
And roll me a
D10. D10?
Uh-oh.
How about into the candle? Good thing these are fake candles.
Are they?
I got a 10.
I get a 10.
Are they fake candles?
They're not fake.
Oh God!
I didn't buy it. I didn't buy it.
They're
it
made
was
of
too much
look.
Of a delay.
Look, they're made of wax.
They do feel
yeah,
waxy.
They are wax. No, they are wax.
Oh, they are.
But it's LED inside.
Can you roll roll 100 and let me know what you get?
So I rolled a 10 and now I roll 100.
Yep.
Okay, good. Now roll a D70. It's a 92. 92.
You shit yourself.
It's not.
Perpetually.
If that is what it says in the book, I will eat this paper plate. If a 92 is shitting yourself.
You okay? Yeah.
Just smack yourself? I will piece by piece eat this paper plate. And no
hey.
Making it up.
Hey, Wes.
Nope. We would need to see that.
Edits.
Whoa, look at that.
Short
shits himself.
And the role of exactly
Chaosium was oddly specific.
Wandering compulsion. Academia.
What?
I don't know.
Academia?
No, it's E-C-D-E-M-I-O-M-A-N-I-A.
I don't, that was just a string of letters that were said.
Language of origin?
E-C-D-E-M-I-O-M-A-N-I-A. That's the,
can
that's
you
the
use that in a sentence?
Exactly. No, I can't.
Ectiomena?
Ectiomania. That's about as close as it's going to get.
Ectomania.
It's a wander. You have a compulsion to wander now.
Okay.
Oh,
which
so
is
like,
the opposite
so like
of what she wants you to do.
Bye.
You just start walking, right?
I guess.
And you start wandering down that way.
You wander towards the...
Can I wander into a subject cell? That's probably not better.
Sure,
I'll wander straight.
Wander into the circular door.
Nah.
Okay. So you start running there, and she's like, where are you going?
I don't know.
And she presses hard on your brain to make you change your mind.
Ow.
Make a sand check.
Damn it. Made it. No.
Reroll it.
Fool me once. Failed it.
All right. He gave me
we're all losing our minds.
He gave me the rerolls specifically. She presses on your brain, and you like do a twitch, and it goes all the way down your spine.
No.
And your sciatic nerve hits hard.
No.
Yes. And suddenly, you just all everything that you've shoved up your ass earlier comes exploding out. All of the resin. And metal balls
it was cyber skin.
And cyber skin and mole skin and mosk skin
was
or whatever the fuck.
Mole skin.
There was
six ball bearings.
Six ball bearings.
Warwick Davis comes out.
And
he's British, so we're cool.
A suction cup.
That was to connect my Garfield to my my car window.
Three maids of milking. Everything comes out at once. It's this horrible sound in the middle, and your pants just come sliding off.
There's no way.
Yeah.
You cannot shit off your own pants. That is not possible.
Hold on, I'm gonna look it up.
You cannot shit your pants off.
Now this is a sanity loss.
Hold on.
That is not possible.
Siri, can you shit your pants off?
There's no way she's gonna answer that.
Benjamin, your language.
All right.
Hold on.
This guy. I didn't know she could do this.
You take four.
What do you mean?
You take four
by
Siri. You take four for the for Grace.
For what?
For Stan. For Grace making you shit yourself,
There's
and then
a
for the
right
actual
there.
Feeling of everything coming out of your anus at once.
It doesn't feel good.
A pool umbrella.
You take three hit points.
What? Three damage? She got hit in the head with a gun.
No.
And I'm fine. I have my full hit points.
Did you get that,
Dom? We've all had those days where we've eaten.
Dom.
Like what, Indian
really?
Food.
Dom.
And you're just like,
hey,
you take no damage.
I have 7 hit points now.
I didn't shove a CVS
and
up your ass. You did.
51 sanity points. Why you guys, Dom?
Why you guys, indeed.
Thank you for paying for the rerolls to make him do that.
Was
that
nice. Specifically why he?
Yeah, absolutely. That's
I
now
want you
thing.
To reroll to make him shit his pants.
All right, yeah. Now give me rerolls to make Wes shit himself, but for real.
Ew.
It's gonna take a lot, and we're all gonna have to be really dedicated to it.
That's for a different kind of channel.
Or is it?
Don't give me those.
Wes, eat all of these cookies right
now. Yeah,
that's
really not gonna do it.
Not today.
Not today.
Can I vlog it? Is that possible?
Ew.
Social media.
Social eating.
Okay, am I still compulsively wandering, or did,
yes, you are.
Or did violently expelling things from my anus break me out of it?
No, you're wandering.
Oh,
your,
no, you, I should keep walking.
You've got your pants. Yeah. You got your pants down around your ankles.
No, I don't.
You're tracing shit through the hallway.
No, I wouldn't, because it'd probably just get caught by my pants that are down by my ankles, like some sort of weird
make
gross
a dex
bowl.
Check, because you probably do fall.
I've actually watched a homeless person 100. Do this exact same
100?
Thing.
I rolled 100. I critically failed to not fall down while I'm filling my pants with shit that are around my ankles. I hope you're all fucking happy.
I kind of
really
rolled
am. 100.
That's awesome.
Nope.
So here's what happens. You're walking, you shit, all of this stuff that you've shoved up your ass comes out violently.
There it goes.
And the pants come off because of the force.
Such force.
And then you're trying to move forward.
What?
You've got shit goes underneath your feet.
A
you slip
movie.
Backwards.
What's happening here?
You slip backwards and you land on your back.
Space comedy. You're like.
Then do I expel myself back down the trail of shit that
no,
I left by
just,
propelling
it's
myself?
Like a, it's more like an angel. Ah! Like a shit angel.
That's worse.
And like,
where is this
the
happening?
Result of a
right in the
here.
Middle.
Right in
this
here.
Is like a result of a Japanese game show.
Yeah, it's pretty
yeah,
bad.
Yeah.
And you're just at
you
this
win.
Point. At this point, Harley's like gone the other way. And you're just sitting there kind of on top of the ball bearings and the umbrellas and everything else that's underneath you.
Well, I should keep moving.
Do you guys want to help them? What are you going to just
no.
go watch?
Not really.
Harley,
I
go clean that
we're
up.
Over here. We
yeah,
may not
they
even
probably
no,
didn't
no,
even see
no,
this
no. They, you hear it. You definitely hear it.
I mean, there's definitely like ping, ping, pong, 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 bong.
Another hubcap.
So they come around and we're like,
yeah, the smell hits you really quick.
Guys,
no.
We should keep walking.
Oh,
no.
Do you guys want to help him? What
Nick,
are you going to
do?
Oh.
How
you can't,
can we even help him at this
he's
point?
Like, he's like in this stuff trying to get up.
Here I go.
Nick, come back the other way. There's a bathroom.
No, I should go this way.
No, we Nick, let's get you cleaned up.
Well,
who wants to volunteer to pick him up? He's probably real slick.
Well, we can't just leave
I like
him there.
How you're fighting it. Like, no, no, no.
What about your vomiting?
What about it? It's I just don't like gore.
This
oh,
is
okay.
pretty, like, this is.
I mean, it's very
this
visceral.
Is the worst that it's ever been.
It's not gore.
But it's not gore.
I'm sure that there's some blood
it's
in
gross.
It.
There's, yeah.
Ew.
You can't not pop it.
I mean, there probably is.
Yeah,
I don't
corn.
It. Don't care for it.
I'm going to say that it is
it goes
gore.
Right through you.
I'm going to totally say that it's gory. It is. It yeah. has to be.
An umbrella came out.
What am I rolling?
Con. You failed.
An open umbrella that came out the wrong way.
Yeah, you get really, you start like just.
I'm going to run to the bathroom.
All right, so you run to the bathroom.
We should keep moving. They're going to suspect.
Nick.
You've got to look busy.
Nick.
Hold on, I should go back up top. I should get the car. I'll go back
Nick.
Up.
Who's that supposed to be a hack cell? Who said these guys?
You know
yeah.
who? The people that we forced to
you
read.
You killed your
languages.
Way. You guys
killed them.
You guys killed your way down to Knot, okay? And then you killed Knot. So you really have only yourself to blame.
Well, so, it wasn't our fault that we got kidnapped and then they confused us and killed all of the people because they got information from us.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's when that's when the killing of good people started happening with this group.
Did
anyway.
It?
I think it instantly, the first game.
Yeah.
Nick,
remember
Nick,
you were
Nick,
in a bar
Nick,
and you
bathroom.
Opened
it? You're going to go to the bathroom and clean
I
up.
Go upstairs.
You're going to go to the bathroom and clean
do
up.
Do a persuade
I'll
roll.
I'll go upstairs.
They're going to suspect.
I'll go upstairs.
Do a persuade roll.
I should persuade him.
Persuade
yeah,
is.
I have 15.
Yeah.
I have 15.
Okay, you do persuade him.
Okay.
Hey,
if
hey,
done.
Nick, buddy.
Hey.
You need to
Who's
calm down.
Who's got the ideas around here?
Nick. Nick, 59 over my 50. Do what you want, man. What do you want?
So, halfway up the elevator ride, you kind of...
Let me go.
Yeah.
Yeah. Going up
I mean, I
could
do
you stop him? Do you physically...
Can I try and
I guess
persuade
I should
him?
I'm pretty strong.
Who's going to physically grab me?
I mean...
Which one of you?
I can
my
try and persuade him.
My constitution's pretty high.
Remember, Terry, you're kind of a queasy shitter, too.
Yeah.
Let me try and persuade him.
All right.
No, not listening to you.
Oh, no, no,
guys,
no.
Guys, listen. I know what to do in this situation, okay? And we've got to keep things looking real casual.
Are you flicking? You're flicking shit off your hand. No! No! No, no!
Make a con check for me.
Oh, lordy.
Nope. Nope, I failed. I failed.
Yeah. You're feeling queasy yourself. You need to go to the restroom, too.
Hi. Hold that thought.
All right, so they can't stop you. You get up in the...
Keep it going, all right? I've got it all 5x5 upstairs.
So about halfway up the ride to get to the top, you suddenly kind of start coming out of your mania, and you realize that you've got your pants halfway up, and you're kind of holding them there, and you're covered. Your shit slick back hair is is kind of starting to
shit black hair.
Oh. And yeah, and you kind of come out of your mental situation.
It's the worst. That is the worst part about
also,
this.
Also, I don't know if you guys are hearing this, but every now and then there's a periodic noise coming out of that. Okay, good. Is not
that,
just me.
Are you sure that that's the soundtrack?
Pretty sure.
Yeah.
I can't.
They're really good.
They are.
Whoops.
So you're heading back up, and it gets to the top, and the door opens. Roll a luck roll.
8.
Awesome. Well. Nobody's there. You're lucky.
Ding. Go back. Wait, do you have a change of pants?
Nobody's there?
No.
Okay. Did we have any extra clothes in the car?
With an 8?
Yeah, I'll give you.
Okay. I'm gonna go up in there and close the thing and change out of my shit clothes.
Is there a
bottle of water?
Bottle of water, maybe.
You could also just grab those clothes, go back downstairs, and go to the bathroom.
Yeah, that. With a crate on the dolly. The voice in my head that sounds a lot like Evie. I'll do that.
All right, so you go back down. So far, this is going smashing. You get back downstairs, and again, in your head, you hear, Grace trying to reach out to you as you're cleaning up. She's very excited that you're there.
You just made me shit myself.
I didn't mean to. You're very high strung, I guess. I just want you to come and talk to me.
We don't squeeze another person's sphincter muscles, all right?
I didn't squeeze it. I squeezed
the brain part that controls it.
I don't know any of that. I was
just
trying
to
talk
to you. Okay,
well
then maybe we don't press those buttons if we don't know what they
do. And you're washing your hands as you're talking.
Bless you.
Do I just hear Terry, in the stall?
What are you doing? It's okay. I didn't touch any of your shit buttons.
All right. So you guys get cleaned up, and a lot of time has passed because it takes a while. So now you're behind schedule. What do you guys want to do?
Go into the lab, see what's in the lab.
Okay, so you open up the door, and there are all of these large creatures in these cages that are hanging from spheres from the ceilings. And some of them have these weird wings. They look like specimens of some sort. And across the lab, there's this large circle. It's actually on there. And in that circle, floating in this translucent goo, is a young girl. She's wearing a summer dress. And when you see her, you automatically start getting, all of you, except for you, start getting flashbacks of the first time that you met her at the church. And her eyes are closed, and she's just kind of peacefully floating in the center of the sphere.
Of when we met her at the church?
It's just a flashback of what she looked like when she was at the church.
Okay.
Before she fell off the roof. So when you're looking at her now, she looks very beautiful, very peaceful. And there's all of these creatures in these things around. They're all this odd gray color. And
They kind of look like the finger that you guys found. They're the same consistency. And they start, you know, they're groping at the steel doors a little bit, you know, trying to reach out for you, but they can't do anything. Give me sand rolls.
We are so sane.
Made it.
Okay, cool.
39 over my 24.
Okay.
Nope.
40? 40 didn't make it?
40 over my 34.
We are so not sane.
39 over my 32.
Okay, so everybody, Dom, these three take 3 points. So, oof. Meghan.
Ooh, I'm 21 now.
Meghan, Ben, and Michelle.
I'm at 31 points.
You have 10 more than me.
I'm at 29 points.
You guys
points.
Are now, at this point, your brains are starting to make you twitch a little bit, and you're feeling really uneasy and really kind of off. Yeah.
Get.
So what do you want to do? She's sitting there. She's floating.
And pull out the C4.
Okay.
Do it. Do it. Oh, wait, I have it. Do you have it? I have it.
Shouldn't be me.
Here you go.
No, I'm giving it to you.
Oh. Yeah, because if he's thinking about it, she'll.
Yeah, I'm actually I'm thinking about a brick wall right now.
A Katy Perry song.
Okay, we start setting the C4.
When you start touching the tank, are you putting it straight on the tank? Or what? How are you doing it? Because remember I said, if it's on a door, that's one thing, but if you're trying to specifically blow something up, I need to know what the plan is. How are you setting this up?
I would like to do it around the base.
The base? Yeah. Are you doing straight to the glass or the outer thing, or are you doing it to the metal base part?
The metal base part.
Okay.
I'm hoping that it'll just there. Like.
I'm trying to hit all the.
Yeah,
other
and I'll
tanks
just I'll put
too.
The grenade. I'll put one of the grenades.
Just randomly there.
Just in the C4.
Okay. She opens her eyes and she puts her hand on the glass and she goes, "What are you doing? You can't do this.
We need to save the world.
No, this is not. You can't do this to me. Nick, what are you doing? What are you doing to me? You can't do this. No, you're not allowed to." And she reaches out and tries to reach into your brain as hard as she can. Yep. And she succeeds.
Go, Bancroft arm.
All right, you have it. let me pull up what the things are. Remember, you have two.
Yep.
So do the first roll for me.
It's a D100?
That one. Yep.
This one. That one.
Oh, man. This is like the one time I'm hoping
can
not
you give
for
me
rocket
the turquoise
hand.
Blue one?
Yeah, that one.
19.
Spiderweb hand.
Each finger turns into a different part of a cutlery set.
God damn
soup,
it.
Soup spoon, teaspoon, fork, knife, and napkin.
Wait, did one of them turn into soup?
Soup spoon.
Oh, soup spoon.
So you go like this, and it's like bloop. And she's like, Nick!
Fuck.
Nick! What are you doing to me? You're supposed to love me. I remember.
I don't even know you, babe.
I remember the time. You remember the time. And she starts flooding your mind with your past. let's see.
Meanwhile, the napkin flutters in the air conditioning breeze. That's the pinky finger.
All right, take 8 points.
God damn it. 43, oh, Dom. 43.
Is that a phone call? Insanity, somehow.
So, how much? So, do an intelligence roll.
I do not understand.
Good.
68
so
over
you
my
just
60.
You just take the hit.
Can she stay until 11?
Yeah, she can. I meant Alan goes to bed at 10. She can stay up.
Can she eat a whole box of cookies if she wants?
Oh, can she eat a whole box of cookies?
No.
For breakfast?
No. We're good parents. We eat all the cookies.
We eat save our children from them.
Yeah. There's some non-cold water. Yeah. All right. So yeah, I don't understand what's happening.
All right. So do you want to use your second shot now that your first shot kind of went kerfluffle? It's up to you. She's
retaliation.
All right.
Moment of panic. Oh, last ditch. Go bankrupt. Armageddon.
It's cocked.
Is it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's cocked.
Yeah.
77. Big time, 77.
Rocket arm.
No, we don't want that. You'll die. We'll all die.
Hand turns into an alarm clock. Each finger lights up, counting to five before it starts to ring. One, two.
Why would three, I even have that as a function?
Four.
The soup spoon, I can understand. You need soup sometimes, but why?
Oh, that's so loud.
God damn it. Oh. How do you shut it off?
Wake up.
How are you doing that?
Just like that. Like I did it. Just hitting it on a thing. Handcuffed to try and muffle the sound of the alarm clock fingers. Just like you would do it on a shelf.
I think you should do it harder.
I can't. That's as hard as I can do it.
After violently shaking it up and down in a very semi-horribly erotic race, you hit it on the ground and smash your hand off and have to put on another hand.
At least you got rid of that weird short hand.
No, they're all short.
Damn it.
It's the only model that works for you.
So the alarm starts to go, the alarms went off from your hand.
Yeah.
And that gave her enough time to tell her her sons to start to come towards here.
Let's move.
So you hear them coming down the hallway.
Goobity-goo.
Let's go.
Guys. You set the...
Does it have a timer on it?
Yeah, you can. You hit it for the amount.
How long? 15 seconds.
15 seconds? The elevator takes longer than that.
We don't have to get out of here. It's not going to blow up the whole basement. It's going to blow up the...
Oh, suddenly you're a C4 expert?
No. All right, what, 30 seconds?
15 One, fucking seconds.
Two.
As we start sprinting
three,
for the door.
Four. Elevator. Five.
I mean, we should get as far away from the lab as possible, so I would suggest going down around here
or
somewhere.
Or the freezer. We could run to the freezer.
Oh, yeah.
Well, these guys are coming this way.
Freezer, to the freezer.
Freezer. So.
It probably has a heavy door.
Yep.
All right, so you run through. Five, four, three, into the pharmacy.
Yep.
Two.
To the freezer.
Slam the freezer door.
You slam the freezer door, everything goes dark.
Nick of time.
And there's a huge explosion.
How come it's bad when I do it?
It's not funny.
That's fine.
Just in the terry of time.
Ding!
All right for tonight. All
right, so you guys slam the door.
We make it in?
You make it in. And there's this explosion, and you hear this gush of water coming out of the huge tank that she was in. And you don't hear anything.
You mean the water that wasn't atomized by the explosion, so like the tiny remainder of the water, right? That's what you meant to say?
No.
Damn it.
No. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure I said what I meant.
It's like the water broke.
Yeah, kind of.
She's free. This is a stupid
idea.
It's
really dark in this room and fucking cold as hell.
Window for us to see out of?
No.
Do you hear anything in your brain?
No.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
I don't know. Do you guys hear anything in your brain?
No. I never did. Just
my Do you thoughts. Hear anything with your ears?
In my rear ears?
Check no, those
we
too.
Didn't bring those, Terry. All right, they're too expensive.
Rear ears.
Only rich people can afford those.
Or run.
Yeah, it seems quiet. A little...
Too quiet. Well, we can't stay in here.
Crack the door open a tiny bit to see.
Roll going.
What about
going.
An idea? Do you have an idea? Do you have an idea?
That's my idea. Yeah, what should. Else are we going to... What's can in the freezer?
Can I roll
what's
for it? An idea?
Hold on. What's in the freezer?
Well, it's completely pitch black.
Well, I idea. Turn on my phone.
Yeah.
I turn on the flashlight feature. So all this right. is like super bright now.
So there's all of these corpses in there that are hanging on hooks. Ooh. Where some of them are aliens, mm-hmm. then some of them are humans, and then some of them are hybrids. Mm-hmm. So can I get a sand check from mm-hmm. you guys?
Mm-hmm. Are there any hooks with nothing on them?
There's a few.
Nice.
We should use them.
There's exactly four.
Weapons.
Weapons? 97. You boned it.
Weapons.
You boned it?
Yep.
Okay.
And I lommeled it from right here. 95.
Wow. 95. Double boon.
14, way to go.
I actually made it. 14 under my 21. What?
73.
Oh, 73. No, I didn't. Okay.
This is totally expected.
Oy.
9
points. Holy
sorry?
Shit.
Sorry? 9 points.
I'm sorry?
9. What's up? 9 points. Now, I'm going to tell you exactly what happens when you guys get a 9 on that kind of hit. It, like, shuts your brain. Suddenly, these things start to come off the hooks and crawl towards you across the freezer floor.
Except for me, right?
Except for you.
How many of my handguns do I have?
You've got all 17 with the little thing.
Sweet. I'm going to do that.
With the broom handle.
The broom handle.
I don't have the time to set that up. I'm just going to...
I just went out of the freezer.
Okay, yeah, you're freaking out. These things are crawling towards you, and they're pulling themselves off the hooks. So you're hearing this, like, you know, ripping sound of frozen flesh through sharp hooks.
Keep it in your system, all of it.
You cleared it out pretty good last time. I mean, unless you're gonna like actually shit colon
and it's
fine.
Oh, 22.
The screen is off. I don't know.
34.
Just hit the button again. I did.
I started the session with 67 sanity points.
I just didn't know if you had written something. So I was like,
I have lost 33 sanity points over the course of this session.
Yeah.
That's pretty great.
Where are you at, Meghan?
Nope.
I'm still at 21. I did not take a hit.
All right, so these things are crawling towards you. What do you guys want to do? You know that if you're pulling a gun out, you think to yourself, we're in a big metal box.
That's a cool thing to think. I'm pulling a gun out.
Okay.
Terry, what are you doing?
No, just get out. Get out. Get out. Get out.
What? Yeah. Why? No, wait. Who's coming
open
towards
the door.
Us? Wait.
You gotta get the door
I'm
open.
Opening wait. The door. I'm opening
all
the door.
All you're seeing is corpses hanging.
Move.
What are you guys doing? We
I fire,
need to be careful.
I fire.
Get out
fire.
There.
Is there firing?
I fire once.
Okay, so you fire a gun, and it starts ricocheting all over the place. Make a luck roll.
Thankfully, there's a lot of dead body flesh for it.
This is true.
Beep, boop, beep, boop, beep, boop. Where's my luck? Oh, there it is.
That's probably not good.
What'd you roll?
94.
Oh!
Push your luck.
Rolling so many 90s.
Would you luck?
Push. Yeah, push it.
Push your luck.
Push. Do you want to push?
Yeah. No.
Push your luck.
Yep.
He's got a 65. What are the odds that something bad would happen? Yeah.
Whoa, nice.
Always a good thing. Pushing your luck. Mm-hmm. Pushing your luck.
All right, so.
Always push your luck, kids.
Push it real good.
You don't always want to push your luck.
Every time.
All right, listen, so if you want to open, you guys are trying to open this door. You open the door, and you see this liquid start to creep in underneath the door.
Water liquid.
Is from this really happening? Do I see this?
You see this, okay. Yeah. And the lights outside are completely off. It's completely dark. And you just hear sloshing of feet every once in a while in the standing.
Like one
goo.
Set or
a couple of sets.
I swing my camera phone.
Do we still see the corpses coming for us?
Yeah, you guys close the door.
No. It's corpses.
No, I mean on the other side. You get out and you close them in the freezer.
Right. Yeah.
Okay.
Grenade.
Yeah, we should throw a grenade in there.
No, suddenly not in there.
A little symbol pops up on your thing.
Ba-ding.
You've got 10% of life left on your battery.
Oh.
Because you didn't charge it.
You
fucking Terry.
You guys all have phones too.
It's true.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm going to turn off my flashlight.
We all turn on our flashlights.
You turn off Bluetooth or?
Maybe we just turn off.
Oh, I mean, I'm just turning off the flashlight.
Okay. Boop.
Just low power
on
mode.
One flashlight so we can, you know, hang on, have more fun.
Fine. They're sloshing out in the darkness behind us.
Around you.
Well, I mean, it's a halt. Oh, we're in the pharmacy.
You're in
God
the pharmacy.
Did you guys throw a grenade into the freezer?
No.
No, but we should throw.
That's a great idea.
Everybody run out of the pharmacy.
What?
Why?
And then we'll throw a grenade. Go!
Why are we throwing the grenade?
Are you listening to Terry? I mean, Nick?
No.
I start running.
I start running.
Slosh, slosh, slosh.
I hear the sloshing. I start running.
Slosh, slosh, slosh.
Is it sloshing in the pharmacy?
They're running. They're sloshing.
Slosh, slosh, slosh. Slosh, slosh.
Is that another Katy Perry song?
She went through a really weird period.
She was like just experimenting with words and sounds.
Baby, you're slash, slash.
So
kind of revisiting old hits but with a new spin on it.
So what do you guys do? These two are running.
I mean, I'll go with them.
Well, yeah, I mean, I'll follow them.
Sheep.
As you hit the door.
Sheeple.
You run towards the door, which is open, and Grace turns the corner right then, and...
No, I don't. No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
Did not.
Yeah.
I get a chance to dodge that, don't I?
Yep.
Should we ask the Elder Gods?
Oh, come on! Right?
All right.
Were you wearing your anti-skid shoes?
We'll give you a dodge chance.
You can make it, like, hard or whatever you want to do.
I can make it hard.
You can make it phrasing. Extreme.
Yeah.
Ah. Phrase myself.
Hard?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Because you're running full tilt.
I'm going to push it.
You're going to push it?
I'm going to push it. It's a 39. Right. I need a 28.
Let's see if you should always push science works. Go ahead.
Yeah. Well, it was always push your luck. Always push your dodge. No, it's a good... better.
You can't push because it's a
it's
combat.
It's not combat,
roll.
Is it? I'm dodging.
Yeah, a dodge is a combat.
It is.
Always?
Always.
Even if I'm not
dodge
trying not to run
is a
into
combat
the
thing.
Piece of shit, that's fine. I hit her. I run full tilt into her, and I merge with Grace.
I'm just following. I mean, if you're using dodge.
Is it like the end of the Dark Crystal?
Have you watched that movie recently?
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
That's my Christmas movie.
Yeah. And no goo parts.
Do I hit just clothes parts?
No
do I run just into summer dress?
You know.
Yeah, like.
Just the
just summer dress.
No. You totally.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you're running.
Go Bancroft arm.
She turns the corner and you run right into her.
Bancroft.
Scoop, scoop, scoop.
Suddenly you're entwined.
Oh, yeah.
And you're falling through time.
Oh. Isn't that feel every time you. You seek Meghan for the first time
and,
in the day.
And then everything starts to fall away.
Okay.
All of your self, you start merging with her.
And I'm falling rapidly through time.
Yeah.
I roll to resist.
It feels like you're falling through. You want to roll for what?
To resist time charts.
Time charts?
Charts.
Time charts.
Charts?
It's an established canon.
Okay, go ahead.
I time shard a little. Anyways, continue. I'm merging with her in a little bit of time shard.
A little bit of time shard.
God damn it.
So
much
how do you have anything left?
This is time shard. This is like
it's more
metaphysical.
It's more creepy.
You know your colon is like
did
miles
you
long,
see
right?
Doctor Strange?
Mm-hmm.
You know that scene where like all of the hands become an eye?
Mm-hmm.
That's poop. Imagine that was poop.
So you're falling through time and you guys start merging together.
Okay.
And she starts to rewrite your DNA to combine her into you.
Okay.
I feel like we're helping President Reese at this point.
And
we're hurting.
Are we?
It's great, yeah.
And he just vanishes to you guys. He just goes out of existence.
Nick.
And you
do we see that?
Yeah, he just just clicks. Boop. Exactly. And you guys become basically one. You can never go apart, and you will always be falling through time as kind of this strange new entity that just kind of lives in a different reality outside of what they all
did
see.
Did both of them disappear?
They both did. They're both gone.
And so we
just
win?
Constantly falling through time?
Yep.
Forever.
Cool.
Trapped
with her. She's
Are we both conscious? She speaks?
Yep.
Fuck.
But you do too.
You're both together now.
But has she regained her like self?
No.
Oh.
No, she didn't.
I thought at least it'd make it more tolerable for
you. No, it's a screaming hell.
It kind of sounded beautiful up until the screaming hell.
I'm gonna make it just as hot.
Sharding all of them.
Sharding is
throughout time.
Time shards.
Who keeps shitting on us? God damn it!
Just random pieces of shit falling out of nowhere.
How do you know he's not? How do you know he's the king? He's not covered with shit.
Offensive racist Chinese accent, Grace. Yeah. Get ready for it.
For 25 years.
Yeah.
Then after that, 25 more years.
Yeah.
So yeah, you're basically gone.
Cool.
So the three of you, you see him disappear.
Huh?
And immediately when he disappears, you hear her sons melt into the floor. They just disappear.
We hear it?
Yeah, they go.
Oh, where'd Nick go? What happened?
Know. I don't know.
No, but Grace
she's
is gone,
gone too. So we win?
Ish.
Do they need that?
Well,
shouldn't we try to find Nick?
They needed her for President Chase, so we win that much.
How are we going to find Nick?
I don't know. I don't know what happened to him, do you?
I don't know.
He could be anywhere. He could be in the facility somewhere.
No.
Well, you want to just run around screaming Nick?
I didn't know that my Haxel mates were just ready to sacrifice any one of us at any point.
Eddie? Really? You don't?
What?
You didn't, you haven't...
ran into Grace and they both disappeared. We have
and?
No idea where they could be.
Right.
How we could get them back or him back or whatever. We at least need to investigate to find out.
I agree, but that's,
if we
that's
can,
what we should do, right?
But we can't do that here.
Sure.
If it's any consolation, at some point you're going to lose every single sanity point and it's all going to go black.
Oh, cool.
Eventually, you'll just be erased from history.
Silver lining.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
For now, we need to go.
Dom, I have 0 sanity points. Yeah. Sorry, Dom, I have 33 sanity points.
Thank you. I mean, is there, can I like, think of an idea of possibly what
you need to do next after Nick disappears?
Yeah.
You have a couple of choices.
Okay.
You can leave and just get the fuck out of here.
Cool.
You can hide and wait for Chase to show up and try to kill him.
Okay.
Those are basically it.
So let me take stock of what we have. We have 2 grenades left.
Yeah. You've detonated all the D4.
One.
You've damaged the floor.
How many
you stuck a grenade in the C4, and I had one.
Right, okay. Yeah. So, 1 grenade.
At some point.
4.
That doesn't work.
Suck it, time.
4 handguns. An AK-74.
An old one, though.
Yeah.
Right. I mean, we could just hide in the supply closet and just
It seems like
shoot
we should
people.
Try and take President Chase out if
I
we have the opportunity
should.
To.
Okay, then I suggest that we hang out either in the supply closet or in the trash area.
Supply closet seems like the better plan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So do you guys like shut the door and of the lab and
yeah,
because obviously
like
you guys
it's...
have done damage to the computer systems. Everything's gone off. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, so mm-hmm. when they show up and come downstairs, mm-hmm. you're gonna have to deal with the first crew of doctors and then just wait for him to show up.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, we could take the place of the doctors.
That's a good idea, yeah, and just knock some of them out.
We could just or kill them.
Mm-hmm.
But
I mean,
you know, if you want to just knock them out, that's fine too.
Whatever.
I like that idea.
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's TK421 these.
Okay. People. So you guys wait, and a few hours go by, and the first set of people show up. They haven't been in the lab. You hear them come down the elevator. Are you just going to get them in this main
part here? Yeah, like when they're like, what the?
Okay.
Like when we hear them like entering the lab.
All right. So you do that, and you hear them enter in, and you get them by surprise. It's
yeah.
Not
like I wanna like karate chop them.
Okay. You do like a Kirk move. And,
yeah.
Okay. And they drop. Okay. Yeah. And then you guys get dressed up. And,
yeah, yeah.
And you've got the masks on.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And mm-hmm. You clean up the best you can and hide the bodies.
This would have been easier with Nick. He knew his way around a mob. Yeah.
Wonder where he's.
We'll have to find him next.
Tom, I have 32 sanity points. So what's your favorite color? What pants do you like?
Purple!
They said, what pants do you like? Pretty sure that's what
these pants!
I only wear these pants! Oh, I've been waiting for
now
this so
long. Now you're in the
Renaissance. All I've wanted to do is
yawn
be with
pants.
You. Yawn pants. All I've wanted to do is be with you forever, and that's what's happened finally. I've been planning this the whole time, to be with you, Nick, through all of time. You're mine, and I love you so much. So
he has 31 points.
Yeah, 31 points of sanity now.
If anyone wants to buy Nick sanity,
oh,
you can still do that.
That's cruel at this point.
You animals.
You can totally do that. I'm not saying you should, but I'm saying you should.
Is he existing at all time points at once?
No. It's just this constant loop.
I thought we were falling backwards through time forever.
Yeah, backwards, and then you loop up back to the top and fall back down.
I mean,
down.
Obviously.
Come on, isn't time infinite, though?
No, time is
it's
a flat circle.
Infinite. No, it's a circle. It is.
Have you not
it's a
seen
circle?
That?
It's
have
not
you,
a sphere.
Have you not?
It's more of an undulating snake.
I thought it was a big ball of wibbly wobbly timey wimey stuff.
No.
Pretty sure it is.
Mostly time is like the inside of your daughter's.
Prove it.
What? Bedroom.
Where are we going with this?
What?
The inside
what?
Of your daughter's bedroom.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Awkward pauses there.
Inside of your daughter's.
You're way too long.
Bedroom.
Wes, make a sand check.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, so you guys are dressed like cartoon doctors now.
Yes. Ooh, one of us should get on top of the other one's shoulders.
Big lab
so
coat.
We're really tall.
Why is that doctor 11 feet tall?
Hello.
You're not three young children dressed up.
Wait, why do you assume you're the top part?
I think proportionally that would be wrong.
Why is he shaped like a martini glass and 11 feet tall?
Do you hear cracking of the bones?
So fine, that plan won't work. Moving on.
So finally, you security comes in. They check out the room. They check you guys out.
Yep. Just
the
doctoring.
Table. Now, you give me a luck roll just to see if they don't notice the fact that you guys have cleaned up and, like...
Just Terry?
Yeah, just Terry.
It's perfectly fine.
Okay. So they ask you about the, the large break in the glass, and you just kind of bullshit your way through it. Like, oh, we had to move her to a new cylinder or something.
Yep. She's in maintenance.
She's fine. We had a bit of a trouble with the glass.
There was a earthquake. This is California. You didn't feel the quake? It was a 2.5. It's
and
really lousy.
They roll Chase in on a
gurney
and he's lost a lot of weight. He probably he's in his 90s at this point. And he's got, the liver spots and heavily breathing into his mask.
Still just orange as fuck.
Orange, really tiny hands.
Robot hands or just normal hands?
Just little hands, like baby hands.
I didn't think that he would like.
Short robot hands.
Oh, yeah. They were Chase hands.
And
after Chase.
It was the Chase 2000.
They, the nurses come in and say,
is he prepped? Is he ready?
Yeah, he's ready. We started the anesthesia. He's ready to go.
Okay. I'd like to take a syringe full of air
Oh, God. What? No.
You're not there.
You're not there.
No, I know, but I can react.
Yeah. Is it Cargtos? Is that right? Cargtos gives Nick one sandbag.
I mean, I would say it's a waste of money, but it's not.
It's not. It, because
you just entertained us.
Yeah, just, that's awesome, because that means that for a little bit longer.
I had to 30 because I was actually taking you down.
Well, it's back at 31, I guess.
So for some reason, as you're tumbling through time, you know, she says something like, oh, I can feel all of you. And suddenly your brain kind of does a twitch. And
yeah, you're just like, what?
why do I feel normal all of a sudden? And then it goes away really fast. what are you doing?
I mean,
how are you going to do
this?
I'm
administering drugs.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah. You have drugs.
Yeah. So I have my syringe.
All right.
Just full of air.
Okay.
Into the IV.
And I put it into the IV.
All right. Let's see if a nurse notices that here.
Does she?
I kind of distract her while...
Pop.
No. I say, nurse, did you check these instruments over here? They're looking a little
strange. Do a fast
talk
for me.
That is my fast talk.
Pretty good, I think.
Let's see, it's a 60, yeah.
Look at all the nicks.
Two.
Wow.
A two.
Whoa.
I fast talk the hell out of her.
A two.
So you yeah.
I could sell her
guys,
an air conditioner in Alaska.
You send, be really funny is if you guys maxed out his sand up to his original
That's
max.
So funny.
That would be funny. So you totally do it.
Yeah, and I say, this is for America.
You say what?
This is for America.
And the air goes in. What does it just basically, he would just have a heart attack, right?
I think it's what happens. It's like an aneurysm, right?
Yeah. It's like he, like, yeah.
It's an exceptionally, I feel like it's supposed to be a super slow, painful way to die.
Yeah. It's
but he's under anesthesia, so he would probably just kind of.
But it would look like awesome.
Like his little hands go.
Sci-Fi Tricks gives Nick three sand. T-Rex, sorry. T-Rex, three sandbag.
Poor Nick.
You guys just want me to make it all the way back around through time, don't you?
I want you to make it back to this time. So we can like maybe just like grab you out of time.
You're gonna turn.
And they're melted.
Okay.
We just cut that though, can't we? Just like cut that off.
All right.
We can fix that with a laser.
Parts. With a laser.
Yeah.
This is why we need a laser gun.
They can do wonders with lasers these days.
Every time that you get sand back, she does something horribly, horribly, horribly bad to you.
Let's adopt a dog.
Yeah.
Pugsley. Harley too.
We could have a cat. Call him Chairman Meow.
No.
Do you like Chairman Meow?
I had a student who
named her cat.
Her cat, one of her cats was named Chairman Meow.
That's hilarious.
And the other one was named Fidel Catro.
That's great.
It's awesome.
So, he starts to shake. I mean, he's under anesthesia, but he starts to shake a little bit.
Oh,
And the guards...
What's going on?
Yeah.
What's going on? This is.
You're the doctor. You're supposed to know what's going on.
I'm trying to help him here. I just put a regular dose of medicine.
Get away!
I think he's having a bad reaction to the anesthesia.
Yeah, they're not buying it.
Are you sure?
You wanna persuade?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Regular dose of medicine. I just put medicine in the medicine thing.
46 into my 50. It's just regular medicine. It's just medicine.
They run over and
medicine.
They go, where? They are you even a
doctor? Are you a doctor?
And at that point, everything goes to hell because they realize you've been saying medicine for the last 5 minutes.
But he made his persuasion.
Yeah, for that moment. But he's been saying medicine. There's only
how many of them
far.
Are there?
There's like five.
I want to shoot them all.
So you pull your gun.
Yeah.
Okay, what are you
his
doing?
Gun traption.
If he's going to pull his gun, I'll pull my gun.
All right. What are you doing?
Pull your gun. Join us.
Is President Chase dead yet?
Yeah, he's on. Yeah, he's
on. Okay, because while they were shooting, I was going to make sure the job was done. But
he's not dead yet, but he's on his way.
Pull your gun and shoot.
Okay,
President
so I'm going
Chase.
To pull.
Shoot the corpse.
Yeah, I'm going to pull my gun and shoot President
okay.
Chase.
Okay. So you pull and you shoot President Chase.
Yeah, and then I shoot them.
Give me a roll for shooting them.
This is
going sideways very fast.
Neat. I feel like we've completed our mission here.
Yeah.
At this point, I don't care if I die. I just want this guy gone.
Yeah. 14.
Wow. Wow. So you shoot a guy. Yeah. You
like it's
blow
slow motion,
his head
like
off.
Paul McGugan style.
You're also
gonna
shoot.
Shooting.
A nine.
Wow.
Here we are. We saved our competency for the last possible.
That's what it was.
We were reserving it.
We were waiting for a special rainy day. Here it is.
What do you think about a tiny house?
I don't think it's practical at all. No one wants to live in a tiny house long term, Grace.
You could shit
like
in
a
the
tiny
shower.
House would be wonderful.
I need space.
But it's about experiences.
It's not. It
doesn't
matter.
Not about where you live.
You're not going to care about experiences if you're shouting at each other all the time, Grace.
You're already shouting.
I know.
In a tiny house, we can have
money
and shouting.
Do you guys hear something?
Do you hear what sounds like misery?
So you guys, what'd you roll? Oh, you killed Chase. So you guys cap two of them. The other three start shooting at you guys.
Sure. Good.
So the first shot's at you.
Sure.
That's an 86 miss. Mm-hmm. Second shot's at you. Evie. God damn it.
42.
All right. That does hit. Unless
Great.
You
dodge.
Wanna
dodge.
Ducker.
47.
Or am I 33?
Okay.
All more. Right.
Dodge. Dive.
You take 4 points of damage.
Ow!
Dom, she just took 4 points.
Now I have five.
Four hit points.
And the last guy definitely is shooting straight for your head because he sees you do this thing. And misses. All right. The guys that hit the floor and died, they have these radios that when a police officer goes down, an alarm goes off. And so,
dead man switch.
Yeah. Mm. And so that's gone off, and you know it's gone off because you've experienced that before. Mm-hmm. And you know that you have to get in a freight elevator now.
Yeah.
You have these three guys. For speed, we're going to start with you and go this way.
Okay.
What are you doing?
I'll shoot at one of them.
Who has the last grenade?
Me.
I'm not losing my voice at all.
No, I miss.
Okay, so you miss. All right.
Ding.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I'm going to gesture. Yeah. And then, look.
Everybody,
I'm
run! Yeah,
I'm going to bolt.
Okay, so you run.
I'm going to Usain
shooting.
Bolt.
All right. So you're running.
That's very fast.
I'm going to throw this grenade at right. them and run.
Okay.
I feel like you should just, like, yeah, toss
like
that
start
up.
To run.
Roll a throw.
It's not really a throw. You can
just drop it.
Drop it.
I bet you did drop it.
Well, I guess maybe toss
you,
over
if,
your shoulder.
Yeah. I mean, I guess if you just want to drop it, you can. But they get a chance to grab you because you're running by them.
I'll try throwing it.
All right, go for it.
26
under my 40.
All right. So yeah, you land right between two of them. It explodes
immediately.
Well, it's one, two, three, throw, four, right off, five.
She holds it so that they can't scoop it up and toss it back.
Are you doing the holy hand grenade bit?
Yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely. Of course I am.
Okay.
Todd. Jeff. Steve?
Do you think those are good names for babies?
I don't care.
I think they're good
names I would for babies. Never touch you.
You're touching
me
now.
You are touching me now. You're inside
It's not.
Me.
It's not by choice, and you know it. You can feel.
Around.
I'm gonna send to you how much this is not my choice.
You're making me sound bad. I'm not bad.
You
we love each other.
You're the worst.
I love you, Nick.
I love you.
I hope you die. You're dying to sleep.
No, we're together.
There's forever. No sleeping.
There's no sleeping. There's only falling through time.
There's no sleep
till
Brooklyn.
I hope you hit a star or something. A time star.
You know, it's just hurting me.
Well, get used to it, babe.
I wouldn't do that, Nick.
I'm going to do it.
All right, so the grenade goes off, and it sends them and gives you guys a clear path. You start running for the door. Let's see. Which elevator are you going to?
First freight elevator.
Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's see if you're lucky.
Why start now?
Yeah, we've been pretty lucky.
4. Okay, good. Yeah. All right. Ding. So you guys get in there and
you
start to go up.
Never find a freight elevator.
In the freight elevator? For the freight guys?
Yeah, that's what we heard.
The freight guys, it keeps them calm.
That's true.
And that's important.
You know how itchy those freight guys get.
Oh, yeah. My way.
All right, door opens up.
That seems
fire
gun
squad.
fire starts to blanket the hallway that you guys are in, cool. And you see people, you know, the black bag security coming down, and they're just shooting towards the end of the hallway. You guys are at the top level, like by the docks where you originally came in. You can try to bolt across and see if you can avoid gunfire.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I'm going to do one roll, and then if it's a hit, I'm going to roll a d4 to see if which one of you it hits. If it's a 4, it hits Nick in time for some reason.
Cool. What the fuck?
All right. So they miss you. You guys dive across.
Stormtroopers.
To the truck.
And Harley's up there, because you guys, I don't believe.
Harley, start the car.
And so you guys are behind the because you never got back up to get Harley. You only went down the once.
Yeah.
And so you guys get Harley out of the thing, and you're kind of pinned behind this this bunch of crates, and you hear sirens going off everywhere. There is the truck and some other cars. Mm-hmm. What do you want to do?
I mean, get to a car
or truck.
Just get in the truck and go.
Yeah.
Just go, go, go.
Yeah.
Okay, so who's driving?
I'm driving.
Okay. So you jump in the front.
I mean, Josie's not here. Evie, you know, is okay if she drives.
If we could actually stop She's in one different. Of these times, which one would be your favorite?
The one, which is the one, like, what do you think your lifespan would have been?
I don't know anymore. I mean, I was 22 when we changed.
Let's just pretend you had a half-life. So, I don't know, like a million years in the future from the moment we met. So that I could look at the pile of ash that was once you.
God.
That's really dark.
Yeah. Well, I'm stuck in fucking time.
Don't be so upset. I thought you would enjoy this. I mean, I didn't think we'd
Why
fight.
Would you possibly think that?
I don't know. I just always cared about you so much.
This was, you did this on purpose?
Well, yeah. I've been thinking about
God
doing this
damn
for a long
you
time.
You are useless. Just like your mother.
You don't have to be abusive.
Wow.
So abusive.
Wow.
So very abusive. Wow. All right, okay, everybody make me a luck roll to get into the truck, because bullets are going off everywhere.
Push your luck. Push your luck.
62.
Go for it.
62 again.
62 again.
Yes.
Same exact thing.
Yep.
Shouldn't have pushed your luck.
I did not make my luck.
Did not make.
Push your luck.
I'll push it.
Oh, real good.
And made it worse.
93.
Not gonna work.
54 on a minus 65.
All right. Someone needs to roll for Harley.
Who has a sheet?
I do, but you've been rolling better than I have. Harley's luck is 75.
He
got a 90.
Push his luck.
Push his luck. Push it.
I can't. Give me my die.
I'm trying, but your arm was in my way. 62 again.
Then you made it.
The fuck?
Harley made it.
All right.
It's 362s.
I know. Weird. Weird.
On a D100.
Yeah, I know.
So all these bullets are going off, and you're running, and all three of you and the dog run at the same time. Mm-hmm. And the first shot rings out. The shot rings out, and you hear a thud, you feel like a splat on the back of your neck as she's hit in the side of the face. And, you know, part of her chin gets kind of ripped off.
Am I in front of her or behind her?
You're like on the side because
so
they're
I didn't
spraying.
See that.
Yeah, you didn't see that, no. But you feel a bullet go into your lower back and cut through part of your spine.
Oh, good.
And
good.
You topple over and you fall down.
It's hard to walk without
sciatic
a spine.
Nerves spilling out.
And you don't realize, you feel like this thing of blood hit you, but you don't realize because everything's moving so fast. You get in the car with Harley and you see all these black bag people running and they're on the ground kind of trying to move forward, but they've got, you know, these severe wounds.
They didn't
wounds.
Make it into the truck?
No. What do you want to do?
it's Harley.
Can Harley save them? Can Harley, like, scoop up one of them and I can scoop up one of them?
If you want to try, but there's a bunch running, it's up to you. You take a chance of getting hit by bullets.
I mean, I love my teammates, even though gimpy and faceless. I don't want to leave them to die.
Well, you got to make a decision now.
Okay, both of us, we try to... Harley's, like, grabbing onto Footless, and I'm trying to...
Footless?
All right.
Spineless.
So you run out, and these things are running towards you. Give me a strength roll to grab one. Who are you grabbing? Faceless?
Yeah, Faceless.
yeah.
Lommeled it.
Lama, lama, lama.
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
18.
So you grab... You're in it. It's so painful.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Throws you
by
over.
The face.
Yeah. And Harley's
grab her by the collar.
Harley's trying to drag.
Oh, 42 over is 35.
Okay, yeah, he's not having a good time, and they start shooting towards him.
No,
not Harley.
Harley.
Oh, missing.
Okay, then I'm gonna grab.
You try. Make a strength roll that's hard though, because now you're gonna have two sacks of potatoes on your.
God.
Bloody.
No. Her. She's already
got,
in the truck.
Yeah,
no, she's in
the
truck.
Oh, you moved her back and you ran back?
I just went like, no, how far away are they?
You're
we
like,
that far.
You're at the, like...
Are they that far?
All right, I'll give it to you if you're going to whine about it.
I didn't whine. I just
like, I thought they were moving.
No,
they fell. They're, like, crawling on the ground. It's not, they weren't moving fast.
So they're getting closer by a second.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
So I was just going to pick her up and then, like, chuck her into the van.
Okay.
And then I see that Harley's struggling.
Okay.
And I'm
Well, when you do the second one, they shoot at you.
Sure, okay.
Well, that makes sense, right?
Yeah, it makes absolute sense.
52.
They hit.
Can I dodge?
I'm going to give you a chance, yeah.
Yeah, don't dodge.
Okay.
Push it.
You
can if
you
can
push.
I can't push.
Even if it's
it.
An oncoming truck, that still counts as combat. You're fighting a truck.
Even if it's an oncoming grace, it counts as combat.
It's in combat, yes. Well, you said dodge. That's all I'm saying.
If I'm trying to run around a streetlight, combat.
Running, yes. Dodging, no. 2 points of damage, though. It just grazes you.
All right, so it's a 9. I have a 9, Dom.
Oh, Jesus, Ben.
All right. So I'd like to...
Okay, so you grab her, and are you throwing her in the back of the van?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Syringes.
they start shooting at the van. Give me a drive roll as you, speed away. What's your drive?
Oh, it's a 30.
Okay.
That's 4 points under Josie's. I'm just saying. I mean, over Josie's.
Yeah.
You want to push it?
Yeah.
So.
Push it really.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, no. Oh, no. 82
oh, no.
Over your 30.
Yeah,
82.
Not good.
82.
These are delicious cookies.
Really good, right?
Yeah, they're awesome.
I hope you guys enjoyed them.
Yeah. All right.
It's important to us.
Now, the cookies were rerolls, okay. Right?
So you speed off, and they hit they're hitting the side of the car. Mm-hmm. They hit the wheel.
Yeah.
And you go straight into one of those large pylon things. And, of course, you didn't put on your seatbelt, and you get ejected through the front.
Boom!
And you fly through.
This is the face that everyone makes when they go through the windshield in slow motion.
And you hit the ground.
Totally.
And then you notice that you feel something on your face for a little bit, and then everything goes black. And that's the end of the game. Thank you, everybody.
But Harley makes it out and lives a long life afterwards.
I mean, he's a dog, so probably like three more years.
We're all dead, but not Harley.
Harley and me. I'm just leaving it where it's at.
Okay.
So we'll have to see later.
Wait, but what did he feel on his face?
He felt some kind of licking on his face, kind of like in the morning that he had.
Bacon?
What? And then darkness.
Yeah. Harley was licking the blood off of my face. What? Probably preparing to eat me.
Like you do.
It's what he would have wanted.
It's what I would have wanted.
Thank you guys so much for watching.
We won.
Actually, you did. Because even though everything...
Classic us.
Everything horrible happened, you did stop President Chase from becoming immortal.
Mm-hmm.
You did... release Grace the way that she wanted to be released.
We absolutely did. We gave her the sweet release of Nick.
Yep. Throughout time.
I'm giving a full release.
I hope that you enjoyed the game. I definitely did. We are going to be starting a new storyline in a few weeks.
Have we told them what it is?
We have not.
Do we know what it is?
Yes.
Yes, we do.
We know.
We're keeping a secret.
We're
from
keeping
you.
A secret. So the way that it's going to work from the I'm sorry I ran a little long, but it was the last game. So the way that it's going to work is we're going to do one or two seasons of a new story, kind of like American Horror Story, where we change. It'll be the same players, but they'll be playing new characters, and you know, we'll do new story arcs and things like that. And that's as much as I want to say about the format. The next game is going to be a one-shot, like I was saying. And just because it's the last game really quick, and we, you know, the people that want to hang out can, but I do want to ask, do you have any questions about what happened during the game? Like, not only this game, but any of the games, do you have... anything that you wondered
I
about? I want
to know what that says.
Oh, what that says?
What does the face-melting text say?
I'm trying to... It's a cryptogram, and I'm trying to figure it out.
Yeah,
that's what
Chat
I...
Chat got a PDF with the letters and everything. So I don't necessarily want to stay on air, but I can... Did you figure it out?
No.
Well... I will tell you when we're off air, because if people want to figure it out, I want to give them that opportunity.
Okay. All right. Okay.
Because you figure, like, this is a vowel, and this is a vowel, more than likely. And this is a vowel.
You guys almost made it. If you had some re-rolls to be able to do your drive roll.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean... as a counter, you know, on the other end of that, we only got this far because of rerolls we had received way earlier in
this. That's very true.
Yeah, like, this game could have been way over.
This is very classic, our hack cell, too, because we did we have never really once failed an objective, just never really succeeded in the way that we wanted
were hoping to.
So, like, we did it just like we always do.
That's very true.
We did want it to go
in. I just feel bad for Bubbles.
Yeah, because she's going to wonder what happened to you.
Yeah.
Because
screw Carter.
Yeah, that
you
sucks.
Had nobody.
Yeah, no one's going to
have nobody.
Yep.
I had my
More
ring.
Bubbles.
Cool.
Cool. Yeah. Yeah. Cool.
Put that on a downer.
Well, it is a Call of Cthulhu game.
Yeah, exactly.
It's all about nihilism. Yeah, that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching the three seasons of this storyline. I had a lot of fun. I hope you guys did enjoy it, even if I frustrated you with, you know, a lot of shitting.
What's funny is when it comes to
rerolls. Make Nick shit. Literally.
Blame you, Wes.
And again, thank you for donating. Thank you for being a part of chat. Thank you for telling people about us. We are, you know, our goal is to entertain and educate and to, you know, bring cool, different worlds like this to you as much as we can. And so with your, with you being here, it makes it all worth it. Does anybody have any announcements or anything going on? What's going on this weekend? I don't have the sheet in front of me.
This weekend, we've got, tomorrow is Masks. Yeah, it's Saturday. So Masks at 12:30, which is our
superhero. Phoenix Dawn.
And what is that? Is that Dark, what is the?
Apocalypse World.
Yeah. And then after
that. I believe they're doing Krampus. Yeah. The Krampus is bringing his army of misfit toys to Hyperion City.
Yeah.
So that'll be happening.
Check that out. And then right after that at 5 is Phoenix Dawn Command. And then on Sunday we've got Maximum Miniatures with Iron Tusk. So we're gonna be painting miniatures at 2, and there're gonna be a lot of giveaways. So if you want some of those, you can also there's one giveaway, right? But then you can buy a bunch of different.
So pay attention to our social media feeds on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. We'll be posting some previews of some of the minis you can buy on Sunday.
And those are first come first serve. So if you want to buy them. You should get ready and
be
prepared
choice.
To watch.
They're really, really good.
They're really good. We've got a lot of good ones. And then, let's see, Monday? Oh, Jordan has work. So I will be playing Knick Knack on Every Corpse. I'll be playing some Fallout 4 at 4 on Monday. And then what else do we have
on Monday? We got Hoy Chummers next week.
Never Tell Me the Odds Holiday Special.
On Monday, right? Never Tell Me the Odds Holiday Special, our Star Wars game.
Is it Life Day?
It is Life Day.
Excellent.
It is a Life Day. It is a Life Day
on,
special.
On Monday.
We promise you it will be as good as Life Day.
What were the names of his? Itchy and like, Lumpy.
And his horny dad.
Yeah. Is P. Arthur going to come by?
Let's be fair, though. That was his wife's dad.
Yeah.
That was Nagelhoff.
Yeah. Fine. But hopefully
we're
good friends.
We're going to be fair about
hopefully
Life
Day. There'll be an appearance by their good friend, P. Arthur.
Yeah. She loves space.
But yeah,
guys, watch it. It's on YouTube. Watch the Star Wars.
He tried so hard to get rid of it too.
It's amazing.
Took the calendar.
Yeah.
So
and more.
More things. Great
and
things.
More things.
All the things.
Things more. More
bigly
of things.
Things.
Bigly, huge.
And of course, like we mentioned, our Loot Crate special where you can go to
lootcrate.com/savingthrow.
Coupon code saving throw.
Yep.
And
you save you some money. Make us some money.
You can also get a discount at Hrothgar's Horde. If you want a cool dice tray like the one that we use, that I just knocked the camera off of, or dice towers or elbow pads for protecting yourself at the table.
Please.
I mean, he might have to make those custom.
Please.
I want to add something real quick to that,
okay.
If I may.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hrothgar's Horde actually is doing another giveaway with us.
What?
So details will be coming for that. So we've got 3 giveaways that are happening at the end of this year. So
it's like it's a holiday or something.
What?
Yeah. We like you guys.
I do that with my kids. I'm like, they're like, Dad, can I have this? I'm like, I don't know. There's this thing coming up. I don't Christmas. I don't know. It's you get presents and you talk Christmas. I'll keep them going for it. And they're just like, it's Christmas. No, I don't know what it's called. Nah.
I'm doing that with Grace.
Forever.
Hey, Grace.
Is
the present day coming?
Exactly. For us, we've got pre-orders for Rothane still going. We're going to be closing the backer kit relatively soon. Doing more audio and stuff. I've got a cool thing coming up in February for a lot of audio for a specific setting. And that's all I'm going to say right now. Beyond that, thank you again. We really appreciate it. And like I said, tell everybody why you like Black Bag and why you think they should tune in to.
Yeah.
And I appreciate that. And have a great night. Have a great holiday. Have a great New Year.
I'm playing a bunch of Destiny, so hook me up if you play Destiny on Xbox.
Destiny.
Xbox, hit me up. Dungeon, D-U-N-N.
Isn't it cross? Is it cross-platform? Is Destiny cross-platform?
No, it doesn't speak. It's on.
It doesn't speak.
But if I am on Xbox One. I'm level 16. I want friends to do Crucible missions with me. So, Dungeon, D-U-N-N-J-A-M-I-N.
Cool. Anybody else before I sign off?
No.
All right.
Last time for this year.